On a cold day on a turf field, you're looking at a team which has a nightmare season to this point with a record of 5-10. And across the way, Joe Gibbs, both he and Hanifin, coach for Don Coryell at San Diego and here in St. Louis. And the St. Louis Cardinals are going to kick it off. There's Jim Hanifin. His job is on the line. I asked him earlier, Jim, what do you think? You're going to be back? Is he going to keep? He has two more years in his contract. Hanky said, I don't know, and I sure am not going to ask.
It's like being in the Army. You don't volunteer for anything.
That's right. Don't look for an answer because you're going to get one soon enough anyhow. This is the third kicker that the Cardinals have used this year, Noble Bojovic. And back deep for the Redskins is Keith Griffin. He's flanked by Raphael Cherry. But Griffin is in the middle. Jim Tunney's the referee. And Tunney says, let's warm it up here. It will be returned by Griffin from the 6. 20-yard line. 26-yard line. Here's the lineup for the Redskins. That tackle made by Freddie Joe Nunn. Jay Schrader is the quarterback. George Rogers, the running back. Riggins is on the bench. Clint Didier and Don Warren, the tight ends, and the wide receivers are Gary Clark and Art Monk. And up front they have Joe Jacoby, Russ Grimm, Jeff Bostic, Ken Huff, Mark May. Their offensive line is back together now for the Redskins. The ball is at the 26 of Washington.
They should run right if they're going to run here. No, they're going the other way. They went right into the overshift that time, Jack. Right.
The ball came loose. It belongs to the Cardinals. That's the ninth time that Rodgers has fumbled this year, and the sixth time he has lost it, and Leonard Smith recovered the fumble.
It's amazing that they would run to that left side, Jack. They had all the people lined up over that side. They didn't have much of a chance, but in spite of that, they ran their innie. Here's a counter play. Step to the right by Rodgers to give the right guard and a right tackle a chance to get out in front. But they don't get out in front soon enough. Junior's in the hole. Baker gets him from the backside along with Freddie Joe Nunn. And he fumbles the ball, and the St. Louis Cardinals have possession, 1st and 10.
Now Mitchell is in the backfield with Lomax. Comes outside and hauled down for a 1-yard loss. He lost a yard to the 29, and Dexter Manley, 72, made the tackle. Here's the Cardinal offense, Neil Lomax, with Ron Wolfley when he's in there. Stump Mitchell, the tailback. Roy Green and Pat Tilley are the wide receivers. And up front, Louise Sharp, Doug Dawson, Randy Clark, Joe Bostic, Tootie Robbins. Those are their usual people. They should do well. And Doug Marsh is the tight end, and it is 2nd down and 11. Now the two tight ends are in there, LaFleur and Marsh. 2nd and 11. LaFleur is on a wing. A little dump-off pass to Mitchell, and he's down near the 25-yard line. It'll be 3rd and long. Tackle by Wilburn, Barry Wilburn. Four-man front for Washington. Charles Mann, Dave Butts, Dean Hamill, the rookie, what with Darryl Grant being out, and Dexter Manley. The linebackers are Mel Kaufman, Neil Okowitz, and Rich Malott. Cornerbacks are Darryl Green and Vernon Dean, and the safety men are Raphael Cherry and Curtis Jordan. It's 3rd down and 7. There's Joe Gibbs. His club has done well against the Cardinals over the years. 6 defensive backs for Washington, including Kevin Williams and Raphael Cherry. There is a line drive pass, and it was batted down, intended for Ernest Gray.
Kevin Williams
did a good job.
Yeah, he really did. And I think as we go along in the game, we're going to find out that Vernon Dean, probably number 32, is going to cover Tilley all over the field whenever he goes in motion or wherever he might line up. And Darryl Green will probably, number 28, cover Roy Green, number 81. We can kind of look for that during the course of this game.
Here's a 43-yard try. It will be the longest of the year for Bojovic if he makes it. Bruner is holding. Good snap. They get it down. Got a chance at it. It's good. And the underdog Cardinals jump out in front. They call it a 42-yard field goal. We played about 2 minutes, 3-0, St. Louis.
Hello. With winter setting in, some people are worried about drinking a wine cooler when they are a whole lot cooler than they'd like to be already.
Cardinals, 3 points, 13:08 left here in the first quarter.
You know, and talk about his concern about the game, he said yesterday, I don't even want our team to watch the Giant game on television today. I don't want them to get emotionally involved in this game, so it takes anything out of them for the game against St. Louis. Quite an observation, isn't it?
It is. Bojovic will kick it off. And Keith Griffin will be deepest. Dick Vermeil, you said it earlier, the best team doesn't always win.
No, I know it is. I think for the Cardinals to win this ball game, the Redskins are going to have to help them by turning it over.
As they just did. Well, the Cardinals kicked off to start the game. The Redskins fumbled. Cardinals got a field goal out of it, and Griffin starts from the 5-yard line. And he is down again at the 25. Freddie John Nunn, the tackler. Stafford Mays is playing the left defensive end. Al Baker switched over to right end. Mark Duda and David Galloway are the tackles. And Curtis Greer is out today with a bad knee. In fact, he's going to be operated on a Monday. Nico Noga, E.J. Jr., and Freddie John Nunn are the linebackers. The cornerbacks are Cedric Mack and Wayne Smith. Leonard Smith and Lonnie Young are the safety men. Ball is at the Redskin, 26-yard line. Warren lines up in front of George Rogers. Well, Rogers made up for it, didn't he? Big, big run. And the tackle by Leonard Smith. That's the way Eric Dickerson ran against the Cardinals last week when the Rams demolished St. Louis, Hank.
Watch the play from the end zone now. And he loves to run from the I formation. Look at the good block at the point of attack by Warren, number 85. He goes through the tackle, would-be tackle of number 43, and goes right down the field and makes a big gain on the play. Number 26 yards, and ran right through Lonnie Young, number 43.
Ball is at the Cardinal 48-yard line, and Schrader drills it out for good yards. About a 7-yard pickup. And the tackle was made by Wayne Smith as Clint Didier, the tight end, caught it. There's Jay Schrader. He's 3-1 since he's been at the helm. He took over for a really good quarterback in Joe Theismann. The kid's done well.
Oh, he has. You know, what really impresses me is the poise. You know, he's got the great arm and all that, but he plays like a veteran.
Where did he play college?
UCLA. Just a few games. He only started 2 games, then left. You know that.
It is second down and three. Second down, 2.5, actually.
Well, they got an advantage. Here they come, straight ahead. They really had an advantage on the left side. They had a wing back over there and had everybody outflanked that time, Jack, and I'm surprised they ran to the right that time.
Rogers carry it, and he appears to have a first down with the progress they give him, and Nico Noga, number 57, made the tackle.
You know, talking about Schrader, I talked to him this morning, and I was amazed how confident and how relaxed and how much at ease he seemed to be when I talked to him. He's very confident, felt good about the game, knew exactly what he has to do, and he feels very confident he can get it done.
He looks cool, doesn't he, Dick?
Yeah, he does.
Well, he ought to be at 16 degrees.
Yeah.
And the ball is to the St. Louis 32 and a first down.
Jerry Rome has done a real good job with the backup quarterbacks in Washington, the quarterback coach.
Didier and Warren are both in the lineup. Monk to the left with Clark. Didier splits out. Rogers again. Knocked down after a gain of 2 by Al Baker, the defensive end. This is what Rogers told us yesterday, that he likes Hank when he carries 3, 4, 5 times in a row.
Now you're going to see the defense he tackles right here. Get in and get penetration and foul up that offensive play. Nothing hurts a play more than guys getting penetration. See the penetration right there, the left of your screen, number 76, Stafford Mays. When that happens, no running lanes exist.
The ball is to the Cardinal 34, second 7. That's Monk in motion. Schrader is 1-for-1. Didier, incomplete. Wayne Smith was covering, and he got some help from the safety man, Lonnie Young.
You know, I think as we go along, watch the end of it here. He leaps up high to try to make the play. The ball is batted around and falls down incomplete. They do a pretty good job of covering both inside and outside. The ball is tipped a little bit, goes right down to the turf. You know, I think as we go along, Didier, when he's reduced out here by himself, number 86, has got the strong safety covering him. Leonard Smith, we look for something on him one-on-one as we go along in his game.
Third down and seven. Third wide receiver is in there for the Redskins. Schrader can run. And he did not get a first down. Did not get a first down.
There's Schroeder going back in the pocket. Now, when he backs up like that, he likes to throw to his left a lot of the time. Junior is blitzing on the play. Duda, number 73, is in hot pursuit from the backside. He played baseball as a professional baseball player for Toronto. Look at this, and he knows how to slide.
Yes, sir. There's a penalty against the Cardinals. There's Jim Tunney, the referee. Without the penalty being involved, it would be fourth down and about two. But there is a penalty against the Cardinals.
Holding.
You know, Hank.
Number 44, added to the end of the run. 5 yards, first down.
Penalty Schrader against Wayne Smith, the cornerback.
Schrader can't afford to do too much running with that cracked rib. He was really in pain last week.
Washington first and 10.
Watch on Art Monk.
Wayne
Smith.
Shirt, isn't he?
Yeah, he's hanging on for dear life. He certainly is. He's in a bump and run, and he knows that if he lets it get by him, it's all over.
First down at the 24. Redskins trailing 3-0. Toss to Rogers. Got outside the linebacker. Lonnie Young brought him down. Good strong tackle. Boy, that linebacker took himself right out of the play, Hank.
Back to the mound by Lonnie Young.
You're going to see right here in the left corner of your screen a safety come up and make a nice play in defense. Not a big guy. A rookie. Now watch forward at 43. Follow him inside out. Get his head across the bow. Lock up. No, he got his head behind him. Should try to get his body crossed in front of him. Good play, though, by the young safety.
We have 9:54 left in the first quarter. 3-0 St. Louis. And 2nd and 9 Washington.
Yeah.
And it is incomplete. Very good effort was made by Gary Clark, former player from the United States Football League, and Cedric Mack was covering him. That makes it 3rd down and 9.
Third and nine.
He was able to step up into the pocket and throw the ball on the outside. Now watch the play. Clark dives for the ball. It goes right through his hands, and he's covered there by Cedric Mack, number 47. Good coverage on the play, too. Very close to him.
Clark comes back out to the right side. It's 3rd down and 9. On 3rd down, the Redskins have been rather good. Almost 44% of the time they've made a first down. Lionel Washington is in the Cardinal backfield. Short drop, quick pass, lays it out one-on-one and overthrew his man. Mack had his back to the play, but Didier had the ball overthrown. 4th down.
And Didier has a big advantage from a size standpoint, and he's got good enough speed that was in bump and run. Cedric Mack, when he's in bump and run, does not like to bump. He just likes to run. And as a result, Didier got right by him, and had the ball been thrown properly, you know, Dick, that had been a touchdown.
Been 6, and this guy has been producing a touchdown, Hank, every 6th catch in his career. That's real good productivity.
Here is a guy who has not been producing. Mosley is 20 out of 29, and he's in a slump. It'll be a 40-yard try. And it looks like he missed it off to the right. He's in a slump, Hank.
Well, I talked to Mosley again. I talked to him this morning and asked about, you know, some people have said that he's thinking about retiring. He said, no way in the world am I going to retire. Here's the kick. And he kicks it off to the right. It kind of slides off to the right, and no good on the play.
Hank, they heard the Cardinals went out in front and came running down to the stadium here.
Yeah, they put it in high and came running down here fast. There's still about 45,000 missed the game.
That's Hank Stram. Dick Vermeil is here. I'm Jack Buck, and the ball is at the Cardinal 24. 9:40 left in the first quarter. Jim Hanifin along the sideline, and he's wondering what his future is. He has 2 years left in his contract, but we know that doesn't matter much. And most people around here think he's going to get dumped. Some people around here also think this team is going to move to Phoenix. Some people think they're going to build a new stadium and stay here. Mitchell in the backfield. And a pass for about 5 yards, and that was Roy Green, his favorite target, catching that one, and Neil Okowitz made the tackle.
Dexter Manley right here does a real nice job of getting penetration up there, then, but the offensive tackle here, this is Louis Sharp, does a nice job of shutting him off to the inside. See that there? Got his hands on him. That is legal. As long as he doesn't hold on, that is a legal block. There's Dexter, huh?
As long as he doesn't get caught, Dick, huh?
Yeah.
Louis Sharp is working against Manley. Tootie Robbins at the right tackle. Second down pass. And low and away to J.T. Smith, the former Kansas City player. And it's going to be third down. A little scuffle breaks off in the middle of the room. Yes, sir, there goes the flag. Somebody's trying to get somebody riled up. Sometimes they start those little scuffles on purpose, Dick, just to get something going out
I certainly wouldn't try to get one started up against St. Louis. I'd like to just let them be like they have been. Don't get them involved. Don't get them riled up.
They're going to call it against Manley. Personal foul.
First foul, number 72, after the play is over. 15 yards, first down.
Here's Dexter Manley coming into the inside. He comes up with a forearm with his arm on the inside, going straight inside, even farther. Now watch what happens. He gets rid of the center, number 64, Randy Clark.
I think that's just frustration, Hank.
Yeah, watch
this. He's been blocked two plays in a row.
Yeah, now he gives him a little facial. He gets one back.
Gave him one in the schmush.
Yeah, gave one, but no cream on the bottom of the side.
Tom Beasley is playing the right defensive end now, number 67, for the Redskins. Drops it off short and a 2 yard gain. As it got it out here to Mitchell for a couple of yards. Lomax wanted a run, but the Redskins had come up quickly, and Rich Malott, weak side linebacker, made the tackle.
Well, I tell you, he is a very good football player. Now, he's not the kind of guy, Hank, that gets in the Pro Bowl, but he plays as well as anybody that goes into the Pro Bowl.
Well, the great thing about him is he dances every dance.
That's right.
Playing.
He's always there.
Yeah, he's always there. And the great thing about this Washington defense this year, I talked to Richie Pettibone, the defensive coordinator. He said they haven't blitzed that much this year because the defensive ends have done such a great job.
Here's the draw play to Mitchell. Mitchell ran into his tight end, Marsh, and that slowed him down. He came out to midfield, and it's going to be third down and about four coming up after Raphael Cherry, the rookie from Hawaii, made the tackle. Mitchell is sitting on 877 yards, and for him to try to gain more than 100 against the Redskins, Dick, is going to be a tough chore.
Only three backs have done that this year. It's tough. Reeks did it twice on them, and in the last 45 games, they've only given up 300-yard rushers.
Third down and four out of the shotgun. St. Louis been so-so on third down. Not very good. Is that a good catch? I think it is. A counter by J.T. Smith. Now they're going to give him forward progress. Very close to first down yardage. That's what the crowd's booing about. It thought he got a little further out. If I had to make a guess, I guess it would be my guess that he's short by 1 inch. Mel Kaufman made the tackle. We'll check the peepers out here, Hank.
If it's that tight, I'll bet it they go for it. They're playing to win right now. You go for it.
I would think so. Less than a yard. Certainly think in this kind of a game, I certainly think they'd go for it. It's right.
Good reception by J.T. Smith. Cardinals are going to go for it. They put in Novacek, the tight end, along with the other tight end, LaFleur. They got the wide receivers. They have Marsh, LaFleur, Novacek in there. Wolfley and Mitchell in the power alignment.
One thing for sure, they will not run at Butts.
On fourth down this year, the Cardinals.
4 of 11 on fourth down situations, but I assure you, they will not run at Butts.
All right, Butts plays the left defensive tackle. Lomax is big enough to sneak the ball. one snap count and a first down. There goes a play.
He was still,
if it was motion or what?
He was still pretty close to butts in there when that play was.
It's a motion call against the Cardinals.
But he was leaning to his left though.
Yeah.
We'll see the Cardinals go in motion before the snap.
Take a close look. There's the right tight end. The tight end looked like, on the right side, looked like he was premature. Doug Marsh, number 80, went offside on the play. Now it's fourth and six.
And they have the punting team in there. Carl Birdsong will thump it away. And the dangerous Darryl Green, number 28, is back to get it. One of the fastest men in football.
They ran the ball from punt formation last week with Junior. Had a big play, Dick. And there was a penalty on the play. They waited
to
snap the ball.
Yeah.
They've done that pretty good at times through the years.
You know, this Darryl Green has returned two punts for over 70 yards for touchdowns the last 2 weeks, and both of them have been called back.
Punting average of 41 yards plus per kick for Birdsong. Was on the Pro Bowl team a couple of years ago. High snap, he handles it. Kicks it rather well toward the sideline and out of bounds at the 6-yard line. Well, the Redskins have a long way to go. Birdsong hung it up for 4.4 seconds, kicked it 45 yards. The Redskins are at their 6-yard line.
See, Heisman.
I looked to him yesterday and I said, John, you going to play tomorrow? He said, no, I doubt it. And second question, I said, a lot of people are saying you're going to retire. All right, he says, nope. He said, they need a 458 to get me out of retirement. I don't know what that is, but it's got
to
be a very, very
like
big gun.
It's
got to be a cannon to get him.
I think he's talking about one of those Weatherbys he bought the offensive lineman here a year or two ago.
Yeah, I don't know, but he's very emphatic about not retiring next year.
Well, there's nothing funny about the Redskins situation here. They're trailing 3-0, and they have to win or they'll go home. First down pass, and Monk caught it. He always does, doesn't he? And a strong tackle made by Cedric Mack. Monk can haul him in. That's number 88 for the year. Last year, 106. He's terrific. Funny thing, Hank. Only 2 touchdowns this year.
But, you know, he really is a great receiver. And one thing about Monk, you know, one thing that he does, as well as he runs patterns and he likes one-for-one coverage, the one thing that he doesn't like is bump and run. Bump and run. He doesn't like that very much at all.
I don't know a receiver that does.
Well, some of the big guys like it because they feel that they can muscle the defensive back. Yeah. But evidently, he doesn't feel that way.
Second down and four. Four on a wing. And there's Didier. And Didier has a first down. Leonard Smith covered him and made the tackle. These Redskins do an awful lot of things to you offensively, don't they? Especially in their pass patterns.
Many, many formations. Plus, they like this little hitch pass that you just saw twice in a row on first down. And I would be concerned they do it so much on first down that some defensive back will roll up into it. Take a look at this little hitch pattern. Now, just usually 3 to 5 steps, plant, come back, get the football. Now he's going to try to pivot, make him shake and break, and make Mr. Smith miss. He didn't do it, though. But they use that an awful lot on the early rundowns.
First down at the Redskin 19-yard line. Don Warren in the lineup. Rodgers. He's good for only a yard or two. A little bit of an irony here. Hank, Don Warren, who runs out of that fullback spot, used to live right down the street from Jim Hannafin. Hannafin's now that little punk's out there beating me. He's not so little anymore, is he?
No, he certainly is. And they rely on him an awful lot. He's that blocking tight end and has really done a super, super job at that position. Don Warren, number 85. Interesting, too, to watch George Rogers run. He likes to run right a lot more than he does to his left, and basically because he always carries the ball in his right arm. He very rarely carries it in his left arm when he runs to the left, and that's why he has so many fumbles, I think.
Keith Griffin is in the backfield. And a pass is caught for a first down by Monk, coming over the middle. First down throw by Jay Schrader, and it was little Wayne Smith trying to hang on with Monk. What happened on that play, Dick Vermeer?
All right, now you're going to see Monk right here come underneath the zone coverage and make a nice reception. The running back to the left of your screen, Griffin number 35, steps in there nicely, picks up the linebacker. Now that 1-on-1 coverage downfield, Completion, first down, move the chains.
Oh, 4 minutes left in the first quarter. And a first down at the Redskin 34-yard line. Rodgers is back in the lineup. Didier in motion, blocking. Fake pass, Schrader. And it is incomplete. And right past the fingertips of Gary Clark. He was flying, and Wayne Smith had let him get by.
And talking to the coaches about Schrader, they say he throws the ball up on top so well. Look at this, just a little bit too long. But he had Wayne Smith licked on the play, just enough to make the catch had the ball been thrown right on the numbers.
Schrader is 4 out of 8, 34 yards.
And the key to the pass that time, there was no pass rush whatsoever. He had plenty of time in the pocket to step and throw and deliver the football.
Griffin, who was backing, he was in the backfield, had done a good job. Second down and 10. And it is caught for about 7 yards. That was Clark over the middle this time. E.J. Jr. on top of him. E.J. Jr. is the only member of the Cardinals to be named to the Pro Bowl team, and he will be going to Honolulu. The Redskins have a few more than that. They have Art Monk, and they have Joe Jacoby and Russ Grimm going to the Pro Bowl. But nobody on their defensive team. That's unusual, isn't it?
I was surprised.
It really is. Yeah.
Third and 3. It's a blitz, and the pass is incomplete. Incomplete. Lonnie Young thought he had intercepted it, but one of the officials told him, don't bother. It's punting time for the Redskins. A Schrader, who is very good at beating the blitz, almost did that time.
There you see the man in motion coming around.
Junior up the middle.
Watch the ball thrown. Gosh, it's hard to tell. Look,
Clark stopped in his pattern.
Yeah,
he
did.
Running, didn't
he? He stopped right there. He thought that he had an open spot, and he stopped, and the ball was thrown out in front, and that's why it was incomplete.
Here's the punt by Cox, and it is J.T. Smith waiting for it. Takes it on the 10. Gets a block and gets about a 7-yard return. That ball hung up there for a point. 4.6, 49-yard punt, 2:48 left in the quarter. Cardinals have the ball.
Woo! Way to go! Let's go, Cardinals!
Limped off. Here he is being tackled.
Coming right up the middle, leaps over his left foot there. You see it being twisted a little bit as he made the tackle. By Anthony Jones, number 82, made the tackle, and I think inadvertently why he twisted a little bit, and that's what the problem was.
From the St. Louis 17. Well, that's what happens. That's what happens. As we watch Dexter Manley with his pass rush.
Watch Dexter Manley, the defensive right end, number 72. That's a great thing he does. He goes to the inside of Louis Sharp, number 67, and he does that very well. You're kind of expecting him to go outside, and all of a sudden he goes inside, and it's too late, and he's gone, and he makes penetration.
Heck, I really felt the guy should have been in the Pro Bowl. He's got 13 sacks already this season. You know, he should have been in the Pro Bowl.
Well, I feel the same way. And man has got 14 sacks, too. Both have been a fantastic year.
Second and 10 and a draw play to stump Mitchell. A big run on the draw. Barry Wilburn tackled him. Dick, what happened there?
As you focus your attention on the running back right here, you're going to see him slide to the quarterback and hit there, and they're going to run off the blocks of these two guards. Now see him slide to the quarterback. He's got the ball. Now he steps up inside, gets a nice block on Okowitz. Now he's up here. He gives him a little shake and break right there. Gets a nice run.
20 yards. First down. St. Louis 37. 2 minutes left in the first quarter. 3-0. St. Louis leading. And a first down catch. Now we're Roy Green. He doesn't practice all week long, Hank, but he still can get something done on Sunday.
And he's a great competitor, and talking to Darryl Green this morning, he said, boy, it's really a responsibility, a tough job to try to cover Roy Green, and he said, I'm going to be with him on him most of the time, and the big thing, I just hope that I didn't score a touchdown on me. He's such a big play guy, and the other thing that's tough for Roy Green is to figure out where he's going to be lined up, because he lines up in a slot on the right side, on the left side, in motion, and so it's a very difficult assignment for Darryl Green, number 28, to cover it.
At the Washington 48, Wolfley blocking for Mitchell.
Becomes a great individual effort by Stump Mitchell, number 30. See, Dexter Manley, 72, gets in there, gets good penetration, spins him around, and then off he goes. He runs his own reverse. Good movement, shakes one man. Now this guy proves why he's close to 1,000 yards in rushing. Charles Mann, number 71, comes in and puts him down.
Mitchell needs 123. He has 62. The ball is at the 8, and Lomax calls timeout. Calls timeout with 1:02 left in the first quarter, and as they were lining up there, Hank, the first thing that popped into my mind was a bootleg. This Lomax has done a complete flip-flop from a running quarterback to strictly a non-running quarterback. He's carried the ball only 28 times.
I think the reason he's done that, Jack, is the fact that, you know, when you're back in the pocket, he looks downfield and especially looks for Roy Green, and if he can't find Green open, then he's got an opportunity to dump the ball off. He figures it's a lot safer to dump the ball off to one of the two running backs than it is for him to run and take the risk of getting hurt on the play. So I think that's why he's changed a little bit his personality, but I think really he's a lot tougher when he runs the ball.
Let's check the Pro Bowl lineup for the NFC. There's only one Cardinal on the team, and there are three Redskins. Joe Montana, quarterback. Of course, he'll be replaced. Walter Payton, Roger Craig, Monk and Quick, the wide receivers. Covert of the Bears, Slater of the Rams, Hilgenberg of the Bears, Kent Hill, Russ Grimm of the Redskins here, Doug Cosby of Dallas, tight end. Dent, Marshall, and White up front. What a good lineup that is. Linebackers, Taylor, Jackson, Singletary, and Carson. Defensive backs, Eric Wright and Everson Walls. Carlton Williamson, two of the 49ers. Wes Hopkins, your old player from Philadelphia. Martin Anderson, Dale Hatcher, the punters, Ron Brown, Joey Browner, special teams.
Yeah, Hank, I think we could win with that kind of a group, couldn't we?
I think so. Yeah, if we stayed away, didn't try to coach him.
That's right. Don't foul him up in any
way. That's right.
I know that all three of us up here in the booth were happy to see a player on a non-winning team like Wes Hopkins make it. What a good guy.
Oh, he's a great player. He came after me, but he's truly one of the best defensive football players in all of football.
He really should have made it last year.
First and goal from the 8. Try to stay with him. That's his fifth touchdown reception of the year.
Watch Roy Green on the outside, number 81. Darryl Green is trying to cover. He's got outside leverage. Green goes inside, back outside. Darryl Green tries to make the tackle. Okowitz makes the tackle, but not until after he breaks the plane with a football. Touchdown, St. Louis.
Hank, you can see why Coach Gibbs said his secondary is a little small and they're not real physical tacklers. You can see Green got bounced off him that time.
Yeah, he did, but after Roy Green is not that big. You think he'd be able to hold on a little better than that, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
And the extra point is no good. Well, that's the first one that Bojovic has missed. And let's watch what happened on that kick.
What? Watch his left foot. Let's see where it goes. Oh, see the left foot?
Hank, the problem was I think the holder dropped the snap. The ball went flat and then on the ground.
I think it was a knuckleball kind of, wasn't it?
Tom Beasley got a hand on it. Tom Beasley got a hand on it.
Roy Green is right here, and he's going to come down, come back inside, and then run a reverse pivot out.
Watch him as he releases from the line of scrimmage. He's got outside coverage on him. Now see him come inside and then delay back to the outside. Now Green comes up to make the tackle on Green. Two Green guys out there.
Let's watch Beasley get a hand on it here, Hank.
Beasley gets a piece of the ball. There you see him. There you see the hand come up right in the middle of the pitcher. Beasley comes up, gets a piece of the ball.
And there, Roy Green, his fifth touchdown of the year. It's been a struggling season for him with a leg injury. Well, they give McQuaid credit for the block. He got his hand on it. Officially, they give it to McQuaid of the special teams. I wonder if we'll be looking back at that extra point. It's 9-0. Well, these Redskins fell behind 24-7 last week against Cincinnati and then rallied to win. Keith Griffin waits for the kick. Onside try, and the ball belongs to the Redskins. Well, that's strange, leading 9-0, isn't it, Dick?
It is strange. And I guess you're going into a game like this, you figure you have nothing to lose by going all out and doing these different things. And if you are going to onside kick, it's better to do it in a non-obvious situation. But when you have a 9-point lead, do you do it?
No, I don't think so. I think it's a bad call, Dick. I think it's a very poor call. I don't think, you know, that you should ever put the other team, I don't care what the circumstances are, you should never provide the other team with an opportunity to get back in the ball game and have to reduce the size of the field for them. Look at this. It was a bad kick. It didn't go far enough. That bounces right up in the air. And Barry Wilburn, number 45, makes the recovery. Now they have a very short distance to go for the score.
Here's the reverse. And a substantial run of about 6 or 7 yards. Darryl Green had Darryl been in the Green. Lineup, and he ran that reverse.
On the reverse, number 28, Darryl Green, the ball carrier.
Watch Darryl Green now. He's number 28. He's a defensive player, a cornerback. Very rarely in this situation. They play action fake inside. He comes around to the outside, has terrific speed. Young has good leverage on him and misses the tackle, but he finally hit from the inside. It doesn't make nearly as much yardage on the play as he thought he would.
Mark Dudon made the tackle. Second down. Rogers, first down run. Well, it wouldn't surprise me to see Washington after that onside kick failure just walk right in for a score.
You know, Washington has been great the last 2 years of creating their own adversity early in the season and within specific games, you know. They've done it today.
The division leading of the National Football League is sponsored by America's Best Back Trucks. At Dodge, we don't just talk tough, we prove it. IBM, the way we put it all together, is what sets us apart. And by Budweiser, Beechwood aged for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you.
Hank, I wonder what they thought of that onside kick out in San Francisco.
How about that, huh?
Where the 49ers will go into the playoffs and play at New York in the wild card if the Cardinals beat the Redskins. First down at the single is 31. We start the second quarter.
They didn't do many handstands, I don't think.
Schrader, the quarterback. He drilled it right past Monk. Let's watch that previous play where Darryl Green lined up in the backfield.
You're going to see Darryl Green right here in the wing back position. He's going to come around on the reverse play off the fake up to the inside. Now, he's a great punt returner. That's why they substituted him in the ball game. There's the fake. Now he's outside running upfield. Gives him a nice move, gets back underneath. See that running ability. Just because he's a defensive back, that doesn't mean he can't run with the football.
Second down and 10 after that incomplete pass.
They got Didier on Smith over one-on-one on the right side again.
There's it out for Clark. Incomplete. I saw a very subtle little shove by number 44, Wayne Smith.
The other thing is Schrader that time threw the ball falling away. That he didn't have to throw it that soon. He had good pass protection and did not have to throw the ball. He could have gotten himself set better than that. Look at the good pass protection. You don't see Schrader throw the ball, but he's falling backwards a little bit as he releases the ball, and as a result, did not have good enough control on the pitch.
Hank, I did a Redskins game 2 weeks ago, and he did that a number of times in the ball game. I think that's something that he'll correct as he gains more experience.
He's 5 out of 12 in this game. 3rd and 10. Incomplete. There was a late blitz. Schrader threw downfield. Baker got after him. Gary Clark couldn't catch it, and it's 4th down.
And the ball was tipped, it looked like. Here it is from the end zone.
Wayne Smith got a fingertip on it.
Looked like he should have intercepted it.
Yeah, it looked like there was a chance for it to be intercepted.
Mosley missed earlier today.
A lot of folks in that area, though, Dick.
He missed earlier today from 40 yards. And this is a 48-yard try. His longest this year is 47. That's good. The longest of the year for Mark Mosley, 48 yards. So the Redskins are on the board, and now they trail 9-3, 14:39 left in the half. Mosley has a new holder these days, doesn't he, Hank?
I talked to him this morning and asked about that, and he said, you know, it's tough to make the adjustment after having such a great holder in Joe Theismann for 11 years, and then all of a sudden have a new one in Jay Schrader. Jay's going to be an excellent holder, but it's quite an adjustment to make. And as a result, why we're going to get better and better and better. But I miss Joe, no question about it. That's what he said. And Bob Stenner, our producer, talked to Joe Theismann this morning, and Joe is feeling fine. Guaranteed that he'd be ready for minicamp in the spring of the year. Wish that he was here with all of us to see this game, and he thought very strongly that the Washington Redskins had more motivation and would win this game this afternoon.
Ron Wolfley takes the kickoff 1 yard deep. Boy, there was a hole there for a moment. He was flying. He almost found some place to run, didn't he? We have some collegiate basketball coming up for you on CBS. Otis Wansley made that tackle. Next Saturday, one of the hottest rivalries resumes, Louisville and Kentucky. They don't care much for each other. And then it's going to be Georgia against Arizona in the Sun Bowl. Both of those events are next Saturday, beginning at 12:30 Eastern, 9:30 Pacific time here on CBS Sports. And the Cardinals are out to their 23-yard line. Oh, a flag. A very short drop. And then interference against Ernest Gray, the former New York Giant player.
Barry Wilbur, number 45, looks like the defensive back who got the hook on him and was called for pass interference.
Pass interference, defense, number 45, first down.
Watch the top of your screen, number 45. He gives him a shot to line of scrimmage, trying to follow him from the backside, and very obviously the left hand. The left hand was on him on the backside, and they called pass interference on the play.
He'd been whipped on the play, so he thought he might as well go ahead and do it. First down at the 32. Toss to Mitchell. And he lost about 3 or 4 yards. Dick Vermeil commented a while ago when Schrader threw those 3 incomplete passes in a row that you didn't think that was the right thing to do.
Well, it's really easy for like Hank and I to sit up and say what we would do, but you get the ball in great field position like that, I expected them to go ahead and go to their strength, run the football. You know, run the football.
A loss of 3 yards on that effort by Stump Mitchell. It was Dean Hamill getting in there along with the linebacker Mel Kaufman. Kaufman's playing up right on the line of scrimmage, number 55.
The Cardinals are doing a good job of moving Green around. He's all over the place, and it's hard to find.
Here's Lomax rolling and throwing, and it is caught for a first down. That's Pat Tilley who caught that one. Dean covering.
Watch Vernon Dean on the top of the screen, number 32, right on the line of scrimmage, in a bump and run, but doesn't touch him. Makes a little delay, Tilley does, and breaks to the outside. Look how quickly he makes the turn. The ball is high, but he makes the catch and knocked out of bounds by Vernon Dean, number 32.
Here's Lomax rolling away from pressure.
And I think that's a very good move to keep him off balance because they don't know where he's going to be located when they rush the passer. Puts a lot of pressure on the defense by moving the pocket from side to side.
He's 7 out of 10. Here's a quick pop by the fullback, and Okowitz stands it up after a 2-yard gain. 13 and a half minutes left in the half. Wolfley carried. Looked like he was going to go someplace. And then Okowitz got there.
Putz is really a load. The big defensive tackle right here. He's on Bostic right here. And this guy is a man. You're talking about a guy at 290 pounds. And he gives everybody a fit. Bostic told me the one thing he didn't want to do is take too big a steps, because he says if he catches you with 1 foot off the ground, you're really in trouble.
You know, the funny thing about it, Dick, Butch came out in the pregame warm-up with just a pair of shorts. I thought he was going to paint the uniform. I just paint him red and let him play.
Second down, long, sideline, Tilly, first down. Boy, that was a beautiful move and catch. Darryl Green covering.
Top of the screen, Darryl Green this time on the coverage. Now it's Vernon Dean covering in the outside. He's got him deep, and Green's got him short. They're double covering. Breaks to the outside. The ball's right on the money.
And Hank, another first down.
Hank, I wonder why they're playing so far off Pat Tilly. He's not known for his deep receiving ability, more his control receiving.
Well, they had Green up in front that time, I think, yeah. Dick, and I think he should have given him a shot to slow him down a little bit, but he didn't.
Now the draw to Stump Mitchell. He's good for about 3 yards.
You can see right at the top of your screen, that's a real nice cushion between these two people, and that cushion remained the same as the ball was snapped and the play developed.
It is called. There's a heater along the sideline, and some of the players trying to take advantage of it.
A little chilliness in the air.
Second down and 7. Roy Green in motion. Darryl Green follows him across the field, and there's Scott Mitchell. It'll be third down and 1. Darryl Green tackled him. Mitchell is piling up some yards. He needs 123 rushing to get to 1,000.
This is actually a draw play right here. Now, if I can locate what I'm looking at, here it is. Here's Manley right here. He'll take him upfield, and they'll run underneath him. Now watch how the tackle, Louis Sharp, brings him upfield. Now they go in, get a lead block right there, and they run underneath him, not around him.
Third down and 1. Mitchell has rushed for 68 yards. Third and 1.
Third down. Last time I short yards, they quarterback sneak.
Doug Marsh, first down. Pretty good moving by Lomax.
Doug Marsh did a very good job that time of making sure that he caught the ball first. He wasn't concerned about catching it and running. He just wanted to make sure he caught the ball. It was low. Here's the right of your screen. Watch him escape from the punt. Look at it. Fakes play action to Stump Mitchell. Mitchell makes a nice block. Runs to the outside. And Doug Marsh is just satisfied to catch the ball. He had a turn to the outside to make the catch. He was smart in that he didn't try to catch it and run. He just wanted to make sure first things first, let's catch the ball. We'll be satisfied with the first down.
And LaFleur joins him. Two tight ends. Tilly is to the left.
Randy Love is in the backfield, number 40.
Here's Wolfley running with the ball. About 4, maybe 5, 10-25 left in the half, and the Cardinals leading by the score of 9-3. Olkowitz and Vernon Dean were the tacklers there. Wolfley out of West Virginia. His brother plays for the Steelers. Last night, Denver stayed alive for a possible playoff spot by winning. They defeated Seattle 27-24. Now either the Jets or New England must lose for Denver to get in the playoffs. Second down and 7. Love stays in the lineup. Mitchell is out. Here's a reverse to Roy Green.
That was supposed to be an option play. They give it to Roy Green. Roy Green was going to come back down to the right side and then option off of the linebacker or the defensive end. And then toss the ball back to the deep back. But he did. Watch Roy Green go in motion to the left. Now he says, whoop. Goes back to the right side. Now he's supposed to option off of that linebacker, but he decided to keep the ball. And usually when a guy like that is put in a position to run the ball, there's no option. He makes up his mind. He's going to run the ball, Jack. And that's exactly what he did. There's no option to that one.
It is third down from the 17-yard line. Third and 6. Tilly in motion. Lomax goes down and flags are thrown, and I guess it's holding. And that may hurt the field goal try. Dexter Manley was the first one to get there.
And man really got up the field in good shape, and it might have been that they were holding man. I don't know, but let's see.
That's going to hurt the field goal position of the Cardinals if they accept this 10-yard penalty. Talk it over with Dave Butts. 9:03 left in the half. There's Jim Hennepin and his field goal kicker Bojovic alongside.
I would never stand next to my kicker. Not when I was in the sideline. I wanted him as far away from me as I could get him.
Is he fine? Fourth down.
Well, they're going to give the Cardinals the fourth down field position. And Bojovic will try to make it 12-3.
Yeah, it was on Tootie Robbins trying to hold out Charles Mann, because he got great penetration. He was hanging on for dear life.
Remember that Monday night when Mann really beat a tattoo on Robbins? The 40-yard try.
He's 1-for-2 this year from this distance.
Scott Brunner holding. Redskins did the right thing by declining the penalty,
yep,
didn't they?
Yep.
Bojovic hit the upright. And the score stays 9-3. From the end zone, you see the ball hook.
It sails a little bit to the left and hits it upright. No points.
Kicker Bojovic is 3 out of 7 in field goals since joining the team. Ball rests at the Washington 22-yard line. First down run by Rodgers. Well, that's the way Dickerson did it last week, Hank. Nothing to it.
Rodgers, the ball carrier.
Watch the blocking up front. Straight ahead shot. Watch the right guard. Ken Huff is pulling on the play, and he goes right through the gaping hole.
Washington first and 10.
Good leverage, good and low, and he wants to make sure he holds onto that ball in good shape, which he did that time.
Leonard Smith and Freddie John Nunn made the tackle at the 37. First down. Give it to him again. Nothing to it. Nothing to it. He got about 8 yards that time.
I think if they just keep giving that guy the football, and as he gets tires, rotate another back in there, Hank, they can control the ball. And St. Louis may not get it back. This is the counter trade play where the running back will step one direction and then come on back as his guard kicks out and his tackle leads.
Second and 2.
See, here they go. Then he gets up inside, gets a nice block by Jacoby. He's up in there. Nice game. First down, or second down.
Back to live action. It's 2nd and 2. And a first down throw to Gary Clark at midfield. Wrestled down by Wayne Smith. But now the Redskins are moving the ball after that field goal miss of the Big Red, as they're called here.
Boy, it doesn't take that ball long to get there, does it, Hank?
Oh,
he just wings it over there.
He's got a great arm, good timing, and that time, you talk about putting the ball on the trolley line, it was on at that time.
It was a rifle shot.
Well, you know, he's a catcher in baseball.
Yeah,
you know?
That's right.
And I talked to him about that yesterday. He said, well, I'm 6'4". It was tough to get up and down that much when he's a catcher. And I said, how'd you hit the curveball? He said, not too good, poorly. I said, join the club.
Warren is in front of Rodgers. Dittier on a wing. First down pass. That was Stafford Mays who got in there. That's only his 2nd sack of the year. That doesn't look like the Cardinal defense, does it? First time they've sacked Schrader.
That's his 2nd sack this year?
Only his 2nd.
Only his 2nd.
And for the Cardinals, that's only their 30th of the year. That's not many.
No, it isn't. They're 27th in football. They're 27th in the National Football League in sack production.
Last year, they were much better than that. They're playing without Curtis Greer today. 2nd and 21. That offensive line of the Redskins doesn't break down very often as it did that time. And that one is underthrown on a little comeback pattern to Clark. And Wayne Smith was with him.
You know, Callaway that time, Galloway, number 65, the defensive right tackle, he was on a stunt and really got to the outside, took a good angle that time, Dick. Boy, he got up there in good shape. He's quick.
He is. I was wondering why Schrader was smiling at him. I'd snarl. I wouldn't smile at that guy.
Third and 21. Bobby Johnson checks into the Cardinal backfield along with Lionel Washington. Third and 21. Well, watch the rush. Four-man rush. They're wisely let up.
David Galloway again, though. Boy, he got around there on the outside in good shape.
They wisely let up when the referee blew the whistle. Gets credit for the sack. That's his fourth of the year. Redskins will punt.
He's 277 and he moves like somebody about 240. He loves to play tennis, Jack. You know, he's a great tennis player. How'd you like to see him try to jump over that net?
There's the punter, Steve Cox. Took over for Jeff Hayes, and the deep man is going to be Lee Nelson. He doesn't do that. That's a short punt. And Nelson takes it on the 28. What a good tackle. Nelson doesn't do that very often. 4-4 on the hang time. The Cardinals get the ball at their 36. Otis Wansley made the tackle. Beating Pittsburgh today, 28-10. The Bears, Rams, and Cowboys had already clinched the division. Now either Washington or San Francisco will be the other wild card team. And this Washington team, Dick Vermeil, doesn't have much confidence in Dallas' ability to knock off the 49ers, did it?
Well, they've played, of course, both teams. The Cowboys twice and the 49ers once. And I think the 49ers might be overall a little more explosive football team when they play up to their ability.
It'll be a good game on CBS tomorrow, Hank.
Yeah, it should be an excellent game. And these two teams always play a very outstanding game. And Dallas has had a lot of trouble with San Francisco.
Here's Joe Gibbs. His club is trailing 9-3 with 5:36 left in the half, and it's a must-win for him, or they go home for the year. From the St. Louis 36, Roy Green in motion. There's Manley again. Boy, he's killing somebody over there. Obviously, it's Luis Sharp, the left tackle of the Cardinals, who cannot handle Dexter Manley.
Don?
The real problem came at the point of attack because they couldn't block. They couldn't block on the offensive right side. Watch what happens. Look at Mann get penetration. And anytime you get penetration, you're out of business. The back had to go back away from the penetration, and that's why it got hit from the backside by Dexter Manley. But Mann was the reason that happened.
Okay, and it's second and 16. A very, very good tackle out in the open on Mitchell by Darryl Green. It's going to be third down and long. 4:45 left in the half. Even if the Redskins win today, they still have to have Dallas win tomorrow in order for Washington become the wild card playoff opponent for the Giants at the Meadowlands. That's where the game will be played. It's third down and 12. The Redskins get the ball on the fumble.
Monty Coleman got him from the backside and did a great job of scraping the ball loose.
That was a nothing play by Lomax. Dick, he didn't do anything. He didn't throw it. He didn't run it. He didn't do anything. Butts got in on top of it.
Watch Monty Coleman, number 51. He not only makes the play, but he knocks the ball loose and strips the ball in great shape, and Butts recovers the fumble. Number 65. Boy, what a great play by Monty Coleman, number 51.
And so, with a touchdown and an extra point, the Redskins could go on top. They have the ball at the St. Louis 37.
I'd like to see him run the ball a little bit more here, Jack.
Here Here they go with Rodgers. He's about to the 31-yard line. Dave Butts lives right across the river here in Belleville, Illinois, right across from St. Louis. Mr. Bemille was kind to him earlier. He said he weighs 290. He's bigger than that.
Yeah, he's bigger. That's when he weighed 290 when he was a freshman.
His wife just gave birth to a fine young baby boy, almost 10 pounds.
Dave Butts, he just got that fumble. And Rodgers just picked up some yards. Second down and four. Redskins trailing by six. Rodgers drives down for a first down. He's inside the 27-yard line.
Run the ball is what they do best, Washington, and if so far they've had 13 first downs. They rushed the ball eight times and passed the ball five times. They usually run the ball a lot more on first and 10, especially when they're moving the ball well, like they have been this afternoon. They got away from what they do best.
3 minutes left in the half. Freddie Joan Nunn and E.J. Jr. made that tackle.
Now the advantage on the right side if they run right.
That ball bounced. It was incomplete. Was trapped by Clint Didier, stopping the clock with 2:43 left in the half. Leonard Smith covering. Dick?
They actually use that hitch pass in place of a running play, and I think they throw it with the philosophy of a running play. Going to get 4 yards, 6 yards on first down and go about it. I wonder what their percentage completion ratio is in that. It must be very high for them.
They do it a lot on first
down. They do it a lot.
I'm surprised, Dick. You know, that's a very high percentage kind of a play, and I'm surprised that he's trying to throw it so fast.
Yeah.
He doesn't have to get rid of it so quickly, does he?
Second down and 10 from the 26. The blitz is on. And they beat it. Clark with the touchdown, his fifth of the year. They had a safety blitz on, and they didn't get anywhere near the quarterback.
And he got, you know, he's tall and...
You're going to see a safety now right up here come stealing off and then come after him, and he's not going to get there in time to stop the post pattern touchdown. See, no safety in the defense now. No one standing in the deep middle. There's the slant pattern going right in there, 44. No help inside. He's got to shut the door inside.
That was 26 yards. 27 is what they say. And the third reception by Clark today. An extra point puts the Redskins on top for the first time. They lead by the score of 10-9. Well, that one followed the fumble recovery. Previously, they got a field goal after the Cardinals tried the onside kick. Dick?
Good field position both times.
Here it is again from the defensive standpoint. Look at it. He's got plenty of time to throw the ball again and delivers it right on the money, right over the linebacker, Freddie Joe Nunn, right on the money. Wayne Smith, number 44, is trying to cover on the play from the outside in. And doesn't get it. There it is again. Look at this, right over the top of Freddie Joe Nunn. And look at, he breaks from the inside. Wayne Smith is in hot pursuit. No chance on the play. Touchdown, Clark.
Well, Schrader is only 7 out of 17, but he got the touchdown pass that time.
What did Joe Gibbs say about Mr. Clark? He said, at the beginning of the year, no one would have been able to convince me that he'd be my starting wide receiver. And here he is starting, and not only starting, but being very productive.
And all you have to do is talk to Clark and understand why he's doing so well. He's a very dedicated, determined guy, very conscientious, loves to play, and is tickled to death for the great opportunity that he has here to play for the Washington Redskins. It makes all the difference. He cares an awful lot about what he's doing.
I think you're right. You know, I just hope an agent doesn't change his mind.
Earlier, the Redskins had Calvin Muhammad and Malcolm Barnwell as wide receivers, but all of that has changed. The kick by Cox, taken by Wolfley on the 9. Across the 30. Pretty good field position for the Cardinals with 2:28 remaining in the half. Stuart Anderson was the Redskin tackler. Christmas Day on CBS Sports starts with the Blue-Gray All-Star football game. Some of the nation's top seniors will be there, including Napoleon McCallum of Navy and Notre Dame's Alan Pinkett. And the NBA with Larry Bird, Bill Walton, and the Celtics visiting Patrick Ewing and the Knicks. Both Christmas Day here on CBS Sports. CBS has just signed a new 4-year deal to continue to televise NBA basketball. And by the way, Merry Christmas from all of us here at CBS. little shovel pass to the tight end Marsh as Lomax was going down, but the fans were booing because Lomax got all kinds of protection and didn't do anything.
He had to spend a lot of time in practice to make this play work. Look at this. He goes back in the pocket, looking to his left. He's got plenty of time. How long are you going to hold the ball? And then finally, there's an escape there. Throws the ball up on top, and Doug Marsh catches the ball. I thought he was going to signal for a fair catch on that last play.
2 minutes left in the half.
Day in the locker room, the big tackle. He said, I'm concerned about Mann because he has such quickness. I want to come and set short and don't get him too much room to make those inside moves. And right here, he does a pretty good job. Initially, see, he's set short, but he gets beat to the inside and gets help from Marsh, number 80. But he's been giving Tootie Robbins more than he can handle all the ball game.
That's pretty good hustle by Marsh, wasn't it, Hank?
Yeah, it really was. Yeah, he was alert. Followed the bouncing ball. That's what he's supposed to do on the play, and he did it well.
Second down and five, 2 minutes left in the half. Lomax is 11 out of 14, but only 86 yards.
He's got a bump and run on the right side here. See if he tries to go up on top to Roy Green.
Throws outside instead to Marsh, and no gain on the play. Well, they sent Green deep and sent Marsh underneath, and right on top of him was Raphael Cherry. Stayed right with him.
Yeah, and then Coach Gibbs was talking about Raphael. He said, this guy, is one day, you know, he's only a rookie. He's really going to be a headhunter back there.
They like Barry Wilburn the same way, don't they?
Yeah, both of those guys.
Yeah, both of them are terrific young football players.
Yeah, they've added a lot of speed back there in their defensive backfield.
And Cherry was drafted number 5, and Wilburn...
Eighth round, hey?
Yeah, number 8.
Yeah,
that's right.
Well, here's a timeout called by Lomax. They had sent in a play. They signaled him in from the sideline. Lomax looked and saw what the Redskins were doing defensively and then determined that he would call timeout, which he did, and he has only one left here in the first half. Well, at halftime, in the nice warm comfort of the studio, Brent Musburger will be joined by two former great quarterbacks, Jim Hart and Billy Kilmer. And also Dwight Hicks and Joe Morris. Joe Morris had another great day today.
You know, and the other thing about Joe Morris, you talk about him, boy, he's got great legs. Works an awful lot on the weights with squats. And again, I think it's very important to have that leg drive because you can't fire a cannon out of a canoe. You got to have that good base.
And we
fire
shall have
a
more.
Out of canoe. Where'd you get that one, huh?
We shall have more from Irv Cross, who is on the scene here in St. Louis. It's 3rd and 4 confronting St. Louis. The score, Washington 10, the Cardinals 9. Cardinals led 9-0. St. Louis has one timeout remaining in this half. They had sold about 45,000 tickets here, but quite a few stayed away because of the weather and other items. Losing record. Five defensive backs, Darryl Green, Curtis Jordan, Raphael Cherry, Vernon Dean, and Barry Wilburn.
I didn't know the losing record make that much difference. You, Dick?
No, not that much.
3rd and 4. He could run for it. He tosses it off, and Randy Love does not get the first down. He'd have been better off running the ball.
Yeah, but that's what we talked about a little while ago, Jack. You know, that's what he used to do. He used to take off and run, and now rather than run, he'll dump it off, and he didn't get nearly as much out of the play had he run himself.
Randy Love is in there primarily, Dick Vermeil, to block. He can't run the ball very well.
No, he's a good blocker, but you know what Hannifin said, that this Ron Wolfley, the rookie, is maybe the best blocker he has ever coached.
We have 1:08 remaining in the half, and the Redskins have called a timeout here to stop the clock. Let's check the Pro Bowl selections of the American Football Conference. Dan Marino, Marcus Allen, Freeman McNeil, Lewis Lips, and Steve Largent. Up front, Anthony Munoz, Brian Holloway, Dwight Stevenson, John Hanna, again, Mike Munchak, Ozzie Newsome, defensive line, Howie Long, Mark Gastineau, Joe Klecko. Tippett, Banks, and Mecklenburg, and Nelson are the linebackers. Haynes and Wright on the corners, and Easley and Cherry are the safety men, and Anderson is One of the kickers, along with Ron Stark, Irving Fryer, and Fred Young, are the special players.
You know, Dick, they do that in a very, very scientific way, don't they?
Just the opposite of scientific, really. It's amazing. You hear your own players yelling, who did you like at right tackle? Geez, I don't know. I don't know the guy's name.
Yeah, or what about that guy's number? What was his number? You remember what his number was?
Yeah.
Very scientific.
Here's a punt from Birdsong. It's his second. Darryl Green is back there. He's a dangerous dude. Whoa! Very good kick. And good coverage. Lonnie Young, number 43, really covered a booming punt of 45 yards by Carl Birdsong. 59 seconds left in the half. Tomorrow, the Nash NFL. Atlanta, New Orleans, Chicago at Detroit, Green Bay at Tampa Bay, Philadelphia at Minnesota, as all of those teams except Chicago winds their season down. And then the Dallas Cowboys visiting Candlestick Park and the 49ers. You'll see that game on CBS tomorrow. Starts with the NFL today. Harry Carson of the Giants is going to be in the studio tomorrow. Keith Griffin is in the backfield. Is out as the Redskins are going to pass, obviously. How about that for being wide open to Gary Clark? And a first down throw, 54 seconds left in the half. This telecast presented by authority of the National Football League is intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Cardinals and the National Football League is prohibited.
Dick, a question. You know, when you were coaching Philadelphia, if you were in a bump and run, which you didn't do very much, but if you were in a bump and run, would you want both corners to bump and run, or did they have the option of bumping and run?
We never did go into bump and run other than nickel coverage, Hank. Good move.
And another good move to run out of bounds by Keith Griffin. He's the youngest of seven football-playing sons from Ohio. Slow getting up is no good. Griffin is the youngest of those brothers, one of whom won the Heisman Trophy twice.
That's right, Griffin. Coached against him when I was at UCLA.
What a family, huh?
Oh, unbelievable family.
Talking to Joe Gibbs yesterday, I asked him if he missed Joe Washington very much. Remember we talked about that?
Uh-huh.
He said, well, Joe did a great job of the option play and everything, but this young guy, Keith Griffin, he was ecstatic in his praises about Keith and said that the passing yardage to the back in circumstances like they were in other years is exactly the same.
There's a pretty good rush that was put on by Stafford Mays. He was working hard to try to get to Schrader.
But there again, Schrader was falling back that time. You see that, Dick? Falling back that time when he threw the ball. Didn't have enough on it and didn't have enough chance really to step and throw and follow through and get the ball on the target.
When you pedal back like that, like he does when he throws to his left, you'll have a tendency sometimes to not set up, you know.
Stafford Mays was after him.
Watch Schrader goes back. When he throws to his left, he backpedals like this. Now watch him get rid of the ball. Look, he never gets anchored. Look at his left foot is pointed way over to the sideline when he throws the ball instead of up the field at a better angle.
Looked like he was making a double play rather.
That's right.
Here's a short one under throw. That was second and 10. It's third and 10. 34 seconds left in the half, but the Redskins lead by a point. 10-9.
I don't know what you think about it, Dick, but I think probably the most neglected position on a football team in professional football is the quarterback. I don't think he gets near the coaching, mechanical coaching, that he should as a pro quarterback. Do you feel that way?
I think you're right there, Hank. It goes from team to team. I think Jerry Rome does a super job with the Redskins quarterbacks. At least I know he works with the backup guys all the time. But there are some teams that they evaluate the end result more than the physical fundamental part of the position.
Yeah, they say throw the ball. They don't say how.
Third and 10. Wide open, Didier. Woo. And he held it. That's amazing. Lonnie Young blasted him, and Didier held the ball for a first down at the 25. He, by the way, was the pass receiver for Lomax at Portland State.
Watch Didier coming down. He'll come into the picture, left corner of the screen. Here he is. He's 6'5", 240, and the ball was thrown perfectly. Lonnie Young finally makes the tackle, 43. But you're talking about throwing a ball just beautifully that time. Schrader really makes it right out, puts the ball right on the money. Look at that. Right on the money in full stride, And Lonnie Young makes the tackle, 43.
And he hangs on to it. You know, that guy only has fumbled the ball one time in his pro football career.
He's amazing. Yeah. He really is. He's a terrific athlete.
That was 29 yards to the Cardinal 25. So that's going to mean more points for the Redskins if they hang on to the football. And they still have one timeout remaining. They use one here with 26 seconds left in the half. I know Didier doesn't feel better now than he did before, but he feels good about that catch and holding onto the ball. Dwight Hicks, Joe Morris will be on the NFL today at halftime with Brent Musburger, Jim Hart, and Billy Kilmer. By the way, we mentioned earlier that we want to wish you a Merry Christmas. We also want to suggest that you do not drive if you drink. Let some of the non-drinkers drive that automobile. The ball's at the 25. First down. 6 defensive backs for the Cardinals. Over the middle and caught inside the 20. That's a first down.
Boy, Monk that time had one-on-one coverage, Cedric Mack, and he makes an inside move, turned the knees inside, and he broke to the outside, and the ball was right on the money. A beautiful throw by Schrader again to Art Monk, number 81.
And marked the ball at the Cardinal 13. You know what changed this game around for the benefit of the Redskins, to my mind, Dick Vermeil, was that onside kick.
I would agree with you. No question. The momentum switched right there.
I can't understand the judgment of that kick. I really can't. There's no way in the world.
It was 9-0 at the time.
When you're winning the game 9-0, why should you do anything at all to reduce the size of the field for the opposition and provide them with an opportunity to get back in the game without earning the right to get back in the game? It was a bad move on the part of the Cardinals.
And who's responsible for that decision? I think it is a head coach, right?
Oh, you can't. Yeah, I don't care who calls it. The specialty teams, in all probability, the specialty team probably called the play. But
he went along with it.
But he went along with it. It's his decision. He has to make that kind of a call himself. He has to take the responsibility for it. That's the sad thing about it.
Schrader is picking up on his figures. He is 11 out of 23 with a touchdown pass to Gary Clark. Ball is at the 13. The Redskins have no timeouts remaining, so they don't want to get hung up in bounds and lose at least this field goal opportunity.
And it's an obvious passing situation then. See, with no timeouts, with 15 seconds, they aren't going to run the ball and try to get the field goal.
They're
going to throw it. They go to the end zone for the six-pointer.
How long does it take to get the field goal unit on the team, Hank?
Well, if you don't have any timeout, 18 seconds.
Warren goes in motion. Threw it away.
Good move. Good move.
Yeah, he had to do that.
Yeah.
He had to do that. And he's still got 10 seconds on the clock.
Here comes Mosley. He has missed one from 40 yards, and he has made one from 48, which was his longest of the year.
And Mark Mosley has kicked 85% of his field goals on synthetic turf. Very successful on synthetic turf.
Look at that face mask he has on his helmet. It looks like he's been playing nose tackle. It's all scraped and bent around. Look at that. He's a kicker. He wants to look tough.
He was planting flowers with it, digging a hole to plant flowers with it the other day.
High snap. Schrader got it down. The kick is good from 30 yards. And the Redskins have the lead by 4 points with only 6 seconds remaining in the half. Well, there's Joe Gibbs. He looks like he's got a little impetus going for him now, a little momentum. And I expect them to be a strong team in the second half, Hank, don't you, with the running now?
I think he did a great job of selling his team. You know, a lot of times when you're expected to win, and Dick knows this, you know, your team, it's hard to sell your team on the idea that it's going to be a tough game. And I think he's done a great job of selling his team on what a tough game it could be. And I say that only because the feedback we get from the team when you talk to them individually, because they're saying exactly,
they repeat it.
They repeat what the coach said, and anytime they do that, you know the coach has done a good selling job.
You know, he has as good a relationship with his players, at least I sense this, as any head coach in the National Football League. There's a warmth there, a mutual respect, a caring feeling in the locker room, and that I think it really adds a dimension to a team, Hank, when they find themselves in adverse situations like they've created for themselves.
Oh yeah, and rally around each other like they have. And the other thing I think that's so great about Joe Gibbs
is the fact that he has a total, a great picture of the overall scene.
Yeah.
He knows exactly
offense,
what's
defense,
going on
and teams,
all
yeah.
the time, what's going on
yeah.
and what has to be done. And the other thing is, I think a lot of coaches say, listen, if we can't get them ready for this game, why we can't win anyhow? You
yeah.
can't take that attitude. You
yeah.
got to make sure they're motivated to play like they should.
Still 6 seconds. Now the ball is recovered by the Redskins. They've got a chance for a field goal try with 3 seconds left in the half. You see what happens there is the clock doesn't start until the ball is touched in the last 2 minutes of the half or the game. And Greg Williams recovered the kickoff.
Greg Williams, look at, he doesn't have control of it. There it is, and Greg Williams pounces on the ball.
Lee Nelson watched it.
I think Greg Williams, he's number one in special teams with 120 hits on special teams.
Here comes Mosley. Now this is going to be a 44-yard try. He just made one of 30 yards. And it is no good. So Mosley has missed two today. 39-yard miss there. That ball just faded off to the right.
He didn't get it all.
It came off his foot to the right, right? Come right off the ball there, Dick. It looked like it
yeah.
went right to the right and misses the uprights.
13-9 Washington.
Sports coverage of the National Football League is sponsored by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light. And by English Leather, cologne, aftershave, and toiletries for men. RCA, creators of video technology that excites the senses.
Well, there's old St. Nick. Merry Christmas to you from CBS. We are here at Busch Stadium in St. Louis. The temperature is 20 degrees.
And
Redskins
dropping.
Have the lead 13-9, and they'll be kicking off to start the second half. Hank Stram for some of these players. The long, hot summer camp, the 16-game schedule, they're down to their last 30 minutes. They'll be playing hard. Both teams have been.
Both have done a good job so far in the game, and I think a lot of people expected the St. Louis Cardinals to go in a tank, you know, in this game, and probably have skid marks in a parking lot afterwards because they want to get out of town so fast. But really, they're playing a very good football game so far, and they're still very much in this game if they continue to play the same way.
Oakley is the deep man. And this goes to one of the wingmen, and it is bobbled and picked back up again by Lee Nelson across the 25. He got an AstroTurf bounce, and the Cardinals have the ball.
You know, Jack, a lot of people wonder why they didn't have Clyde Duncan in the middle of that formation bringing kicks back. But the Washington Redskins' tendency is to kick the ball to the left side, and so they figured that it would be much better to have a better blocker, Ron Wolfley, in the middle. And even if they kick the ball to Wolfley, he returns the ball well enough, and that's the reason for that change.
Stuart Anderson made the tackle. Washington had a lot of trouble with their special teams early in the season.
Yeah, and they got rid of some people and made a big difference.
First down at the 27. Wolfley in the backfield with Mitchell. Big run by Wolfley, and a beautifully thrown ball, Dick, by Lomax. He kept it right out in front of Wolfley.
Plus, he had to throw it over the head of Dexter Manley, who had the real good rush right there. Well thrown football.
That's a tough pass to throw, but he threw it beautifully. Good pass protection. He throws it right out in front. That kind of a ball has to be thrown out in front and right at the number so he doesn't have to break stride or reach back for the ball. They got it full steam ahead and really made a great play. Ron Wolfley, number 24.
First down at the Cardinal 44-yard line. Motion by Roy Green and a delay to stump Mitchell. And he's good for a couple of yards. Wrestled down by Cherry. Cherry is number 37, and they tell us, the Washington people tell us, that Raphael, R-A-P-H-E-L, is a very strong hitter and a future star in that defensive backfield.
Yeah, they like him very much. You're talking to Richie Pettibone, he said he's going to be super. And, you know, I'm surprised, talking about the Cardinals a minute ago, I'm surprised that they're running the ball as well. You know, Dick, they're doing a pretty good job of running the ball so far this afternoon. Most of them are draw plays, but they're still runs.
Second down and eight. Big Butts let him go. Soon they heard the whistle, and that's the second sack of Lomax today.
Dexter Manley did a super job on that one. He pushed Louis Sharp right back into the quarterback's lap. You can see this right here to the left of your screen, 72, Dexter Manley. Now watch him just keep applying pressure, and he takes Louis and puts him right there in the quarterback's lap.
And the reason, go ahead. The reason that happened, you know, Dick, is Luis was too high. He's way too high.
Didn't get a good jam on him.
No, you can't, you know, you can't get any kind of pressure or leverage on somebody falling backwards.
Third down and 19. Well, Cardinals had a big first down pass play and then a two-yard gain, then the sack. Need big yards. And Green drops it. A combination of things can slow you down, can't they? A sack and a drop ball, and he could have caught that one, Hank.
Yeah, he should have caught it. Usually catches that kind of a ball, but I think the throw was a very good throw, and I think is a great demonstration of how important it is for a quarterback. Lomax has had a lot of criticism during the course of the year. The pass protection has not been that good, but I think anytime he has a chance to step and throw like he did on the last play, he's going to get the ball in the money.
Birdsong will kick to Darryl Green.
A return type ball
from the 18. Who's got it? Cardinals think they have it. I have no idea. I have no idea. They haven't signaled yet. St. Louis.
Green. Now he's carrying a ball on the left side of the field with a ball in his right arm. That's where the pressure's coming from, Dick, and that's why, Jack, and that's why the ball was knocked loose. And it's a fumble, and St. Louis recovers. They have it first and 10. Watch Woodley, number 24. Watch him strip it, but he's coming from the inside, and that's where the ball is, and he strips it loose. St. Louis first and 10.
Wolfley made the tackle, caused the fumble. Cardinals have it at the Washington 42. Oh, fumble. Lomax got and lost a couple of yards.
I think he audibled on the line of scrimmage and changed the play there and might have been changing the cadence within the audible mechanics, and there wasn't good rhythm there. Bad snap. You know, the left tackle for the St. Louis Cardinals, Luis Sharp, number 67, Hank, is playing his 50th game. Played the whole season with the NFL last year, 16 games. Played 18 games in the USFL, 16 games this year.
He said he was just getting warmed up.
Now, I don't believe you can play real well that many times in a row.
You can't maintain a high mental level.
No.
The emotional level has to sink.
Yeah.
Second down and long, second and 12. The blitz is on up the middle. It's thrown too long. Green had run by the defender, but you could tell from the minute he let it go that there was no way for Roy Green to run under that one. Darryl Green was covering.
Green covering Green. What color did that end up being?
What color is the turf here?
And how about Charles Mannigan that time? He made him throw the ball before he wanted to. That's why he wanted to make sure it was long enough. Mann was right in his face again. He's doing a great job.
We've got two speedy runners going down the sideline here.
Watch man atop of your screen, number 71. He gets an inside charge. Well, no, he didn't get as much pressure as I thought. I just saw the tail end of that.
Yeah.
They had him in there pretty good.
With two guys working on him.
Yeah, they put a massage on him that time, a little vice drill.
It is third down and 12. Randy Love in the backfield to provide maximum protection. And he overthrew Roy Green again. This had not been a good year for Lomax. 56% completion, nor a good year for Green. Hurt most of the year, not much practice time.
He doesn't practice at all during the week, and I think it would be very sharp to have your hand-eye coordination as it would be if you've been working all week. Those hands, it's a delicate thing to catch that football in a crowd.
Well, you got to hand it to the Redskin defense. They checked right back in and made Birdsong punt. punt again. A low snap. We got a good bounce, a lucky bounce. Dumps it away from the 15. And the tackle at about the 18-yard line on Darryl Green. And he held on to it this time. Tackle made by Leonard Smith. 12-13 left in the third quarter. That was only a 29-yard punt.
Can't see in a punt return. Watch the block on Randy Love right here on your screen by number 30, Reggie Branch. Watch it. Boom, blindside right up underneath the chin. You earn your money covering kickoffs in the National Football League.
Man, that was a blast.
That's what you call lunchtime.
Make you walk down Green Street for a while. From the 23, I guess, Hank, we'll see Rodgers go to work here, won't we?
I would think so. I would sure think so.
Warren in motion. Out to the 31-yard line. Brother, they make it look easy.
What did Rodgers tell us yesterday? He doesn't get going until he carries the ball 15 times, you know. Here's Big Jacoby right here on Baker, defensive end. I talked with Baker yesterday. I asked him if he was worried about playing on Jacoby. He said, no, Jacoby better be worried about playing on me. Look who's winning this battle. Mr. Baker, you're on roller skates.
9 yards for Rodgers. He's got 86 yards rushing. Second down and two. He made his little cut and got a first down out to the 35-yard line.
You know, the other thing about Rodgers, early in the season, they had him lined up about 4.5 or 5 yards deep, and he wasn't nearly as effective as he is when he's back there seven. He has always been an I formation runner, and he likes to run from the I formation, especially with a back in front of him rather than just running from the one back set. He has great vision, and he makes great cuts, but he likes to be back there 7 yards, much better than he is when he's up there 4, 4.5.
He was animate about that, wasn't he?
Yeah.
First down at the 35. Three in a row for Rodgers. And he still gains ground. Ran into Nunn, number 53 that time.
You know, Rodgers ran, excuse me.
The Cardinals knew here, Dick, that Washington was going to come out and run the ball. And why can't they stop him? I guess that good offensive line's
doing it. Well, they're running right now. They ran to the left behind an all-pro guard and an all-pro tackle. And, I mean, there's some physical whippings being, taking place on the field.
Plus the fact that the St. Louis Cardinal defense was slanting a little bit to the left that time, away from where the ball was going. And as a result, they should be able to make yardage on that left side when the line is going one way and you're going in the opposite direction. E.J. Jr., Junior's down.
10:44 left in the third quarter. There's a Pro Bowl performer who's been on that squad previously and named again this year. He'll get up. He'll be back before this day is over, I'll bet you. Well, E.J. Jr. is back on his feet. He ran off the field.
You can see E.J. right here as he moves into the play, and he gets injured by his own player. Now, see him move into it. He reads the play. He attacks. He gets blocked right there. Now, watch the player come in and hit him right in the right leg, real low by the ankle. Down he goes.
Second down and seven at the 38 of Washington. Well, they slowed Rodgers down that time, and that was Noga, who was playing the middle in place of E.J. Jr., number 57, who got in there and made contact.
Yeah, he got great penetration before Rodgers had a chance to make any kind of a move. And talking to Rodgers, you know, surprisingly, he said most backs in the league would much rather play on grass rather than synthetic turf. He said, I'd much, much rather play on synthetic turf. And, of course, he grew up in that environment, and that's what he likes it. But he says it feels a lot faster, Dick.
Yeah.
I think most backs do.
He likes it. He was...
E.J. Jr. back in the lineup. It's third and seven. Motion by Monk. Back follows him. Trader throws incomplete. It'll be fourth down, and the Redskins, leading by four, will have to punt.
Monk that time went down the field, broke to the inside, then broke back outside, then broke back inside again. All the time he was trying to roll and try to get a place to get open, but he ran out of room.
Yeah.
The sideline was too close.
This will be the third punt of the evening for Steve Cox, and Lee Nelson is back rather than J.T. Smith, who was injured earlier. Wilson out to the 33-yard line, and the Cardinals will go from there. We have 9.5 left in the third quarter. You know that earlier today, the Giants won their game. That was a 35-yard punt. The Giants defeated Pittsburgh 28-10. Tomorrow, the action in the National Football League on CBS will be Atlanta at New Orleans, the Bears at Detroit, Green Bay at Tampa Bay, Philadelphia at Minnesota. Everything starts at 12:30 Eastern time, and then the big doubleheader game, Dallas at San Francisco, and there will be a lot of importance attached to that one, no matter what happens here. Well, if the Redskins lose, 49ers will be in. Down goes Lomax. Charles Mann, number 71, got in on him for the third sack.
You know, when you set up that short, like a five-step drop, if you hold on to the football, you're going to get sacked. If you set up short, you better get rid of it.
You know, the other thing that's amazing is you look at this Cardinal offensive line. I think they went into the season with the anticipation Dick is going to be a very outstanding offensive line.
Right.
And already going into this game, they've had 61 sacks, and they've had three this afternoon, had 64 sacks for the year. That's a record. Oh, yeah. That's pretty bad performance on the part of that offensive line. It shouldn't happen. They're too good.
That breaks the Cardinal record for number of sacks allowed. Second down, 13. And Lomax is going to run with the ball. And down he goes. And a big, it's dead. Dead at the 30-yard line. Good tackle by Darrell Green.
And you got to give the defensive backs of the Washington Redskins a lot of credit. He didn't have any place to throw the ball, Dick.
He took it away. The coverage took away the pattern, and he pumped it a couple times, Hank. He wanted to get someone to break clean, but they couldn't shake the coverage. They've been only allowing 50% completion. That's darn good. And when you add the sacks they get along and put that, they've only allowed about 46% of the passes to be completed. That's a good secondary, Hank.
Well, the great thing about the secondary is the fact that Mann and Manley, between the two of them, got 26.5 sacks.
Yeah.
Third and 13. Five defensive backs for Washington. Manley again. He went right around Louis Sharp. That's the fourth sack of Lomax today.
You know why that that happens is the fact that watch Manley, watch him on the right side. See, this time he goes to the outside, and Luis takes a bad angle. He doesn't cut him off at the pass, and he goes right around him. But what happens is that Manley will go inside one time, outside another time, Dick, and boy, it's murder. They don't know where he's coming from.
Here's the punt by Birdsong. Darrell Green waits for it. Washington should be in good shape after returning this punt. Nice kick. Not very well covered at all. At all. At the Cardinal 45. There was no coverage at all downfield, Dick.
Well, the reason there was no coverage, that was a low line drive punt, and it got down there in 4 seconds flat, and that's not enough hang time. Your coverage can't get there.
A 49-yard punt, but a 26-yard return, tackled by E.J. Jr. And now they talk it over. I didn't see a flag come down, but evidently there was one personal foul against Washington.
That ball was kicked like it was kicked in a YMCA with a low ceiling.
Yeah. It was low. I used to stand on the sideline, Hank, and I'd see a punt like that, and I'd stop breathing until the play ended.
Oh, that's right. You start looking downfield, yes, wondering how far he's going to run, and try to get an extra man on the field to be able to stop it.
That's right.
I don't know what happened, but this is a personal foul against Washington. The referee, Jim Tunney, will tell us about it. Tom Hensley is the umpire. Headlinesman, Sid Seaman. Boy Smith, the line judge. Back judge, Jim Carney. Don Wedge, the side judge.
The run back of the kick. Personal foul, Washington penalized to where the ball was dead. 15 yards, first down.
And Ron Spittler is a field judge. He still didn't tell us what happened, although they're hot along the sideline. Gibbs is really hot.
Joe has been mad at the officials for the last couple weeks, and you know that grows. About the fourth time you're mad at them, usually it costs you $1,500.
The ball is at the Redskin 39. 7:44 left in the third quarter. Redskins leading by four. Kind of looks like the Washington defensive unit has things pretty well in hand. try to move the ball.
If they run the ball, they ought to run to the right. Now they shifted. The defense changed, but they're going to run it anyhow. Here they come.
Rodgers, big man that is, and he is, gets outside, and he's very close to a first down. We spent the last couple of minutes trying to find the reason for the personal foul, but we couldn't. George Rogers on first down. Look at that average. 7.5 yards, and he got 11 this trip.
And he said, you know, talking to him yesterday, he said, I get just about get warmed up after I carry the ball about 15 times. And he gets better and better as the game progresses. And I think the great backs are always much better in the fourth quarter than they are in the first.
David Galloway made that tackle at the Cardinal 48. Give it to him again, Mr. Schrader. Outside, inside, and about 3 yards on the play.
Same play going left that they just ran going right. They love to run that. They call it their counter tray. And Joe Gibbs told me a couple of years ago they actually got that play from the University of Nebraska. And everybody in the league runs that thing now, Hank. You'll see what I'm talking about here now is the offensive linemen here will both pull the left kick out and lead, and the fullback steps here, allowing them to get in front of him, and then off he goes. Everybody in the league is running this thing now.
Rodgers has
one. See the mock right there? Then he goes.
And back to live action. Rodgers has 110 rushing yards. Second and 7. Art Monk. It's going to be third down and 1.5 yards. And the Redskins are moving the ball. Wayne Smith made the tackle.
You know, talking about Rodgers, we asked him yesterday, you know, why he always carried the ball in his right arm, even when he ran to his left. That's where he gets a lot of trouble. And he's got a pin in his right shoulder. And as a result, he says it feels a little bit more secure with the ball in his right hand, because in the event he falls or gets hit, he's got the security of the ball to help soften the blow. And that's why he carries it always in the right arm.
He needs 3 more yards for 1,000 this year. He has a first down. Rodgers has a first down, and he has about 999 rushing yards. Lonnie Young tackled it. Now the Redskins hanging out of the ball. This is what Joe Gibbs wanted to do today and every Sunday.
That's their basic philosophy, to control the football. The only thing I think they've really dropped off in is getting production touchdown-wise out of their wide receivers. They're not scoring anywhere close to the points they've scored in the last couple of years.
Well, to demonstrate this point, Dick, it's a good point. In 1983, they scored every 33 points a game, 84, 26 points a game, and 85 down to 18 points a game.
First down pass. Clark out of bounds after getting big yards. He has a first down with 4:50 left in the quarter. Wayne Smith bumped him out.
You know, that Clark reminds me of Charlie Brown that played the same position for
really?
The Redskins.
Yeah, they run a lot alike.
They run alike. They look alike. You know, the shorts get about 5'9½", 5'10", and they shake and break about the same.
Washington first and 10 at the St. Louis.
Here's what's happening in the league this year, and you can see that Gary Clark and Art Monk lead the duos around the league by a goodly margin. Clark has caught 5 today. First down at the 26. Underneath to Clark. Looks like they could do this stuff all day, Hank.
Well, that time he started in motion to his right and then went back to his left, broke out in the flat, and Wayne Smith was trying to cover him, was way inside on the play, and as a result, you see, watch him come in motion to the right. Now, then he goes back to the left. Now he breaks out on the flat. Watch him break out on the flat and see there, Cedric Mack, who was supposed to be with him, wasn't with him. He had a lot of room, and he makes the catch for the first down.
And he picked up 8 yards.
Or close to the first down, I should say.
Second and 2. Okay, and Rodgers slips and falls.
Boy, he had it.
He is a first down.
He had a hole there.
Hole.
Yeah, he did. Counter Trey again.
Yeah.
You know, the funny thing about it is you watch Washington play, you invariably think, boy, they must have about 200 running plays.
I know.
Yeah, but they play a lot of formations. You know, they go into the game, they got 6 plays. That's all they got, is 6 basic plays, and that's all they run. They repeat them with a lot of different formations
and movement.
That's right. They just move the chains and doing a great job with it.
They're going to measure here, but to my mind, they don't really have to. It's going to be a first down, and that is the third 1,000-yard season for George Rogers in the National Football League.
Rogers sort of likes to run against St. Louis. You know, his best game ever as a runner was against St. Louis. He ran for 206 yards.
113 today. That is a first down run.
You mentioned St. Louis, and he just smiles, doesn't he?
Watch the offensive line here as they come off the football. Left guard, left tackle pulling. Mark Grimm, 68, kicks out right there. And see the holding. He slips going back in right behind Jacoby, number 66.
And the guy that did a good job there was Didier. Boy, yeah. He had a good block on the linebacker.
First down at the 16. Big run. About 9 yards on that one before none tackled him. By the way,
Mark May right here, the big offensive tackle, get the linebacker. Here he is coming off the ball. He's a big lineman. See him come off. He comes up. Boom. He picks up the linebacker nicely, who was supposed to fill that hole, but he couldn't get there because Mark May did his job.
And Rogers wants Mark May to get a little more credit than he has been receiving.
He thinks he doesn't get as much credit because Jacoby gets all the products.
And Stafford Mays, that kind of defensive end, was supposed to be trapped. He came across there so tough, they didn't even have to trap him.
Second down and one, and now first and goal. First and goal. There's no stopping this Washington offensive line for the Cardinals today, or the running of Rogers. Dudah made the tackle. And you certainly do have the feeling that if the Redskins, leading by four now, get seven here, this one is over the way they've been stifling the Cardinal offense.
Yeah, school will be out. The bell will start to ring, I think, Jack. And, you know, when you talk about the offensive line, you talk about Jacoby. He's over 300 pounds. Grimm is 280. Bostic is 260. Puff is 265. And, of course, Mark May is about 300. It's a lot of beef.
Wansley is in there at the up back position. And Rogers goes to the goal line, but not over.
That's one thing when you play Washington. Nobody asks, where's the beef?
That's right. They line up. They know right where they are.
Yeah, that's right.
You know, that Russ Grimm hasn't even been practicing. He's been banged up. He just plays the game.
How about Raleigh McKenzie? McKenzie. We'll watch the blocking of the tight end here.
Nice block right there by Didier, number 86, on the kickout block.
He picks off the safety man, Leonard Smith. Second and goal. Easy. Easy touchdown. And Gibbs punches the air. 19-9.
We talked about Grimm a moment ago. He's been hurt a lot and, as a result, hasn't been able to practice. So Raleigh McKenzie has had to take all of the work in practice. So we'll be right back with this story in a minute.
Washington, number three, Mark Wansley.
Here we go, straight ahead. Good block by Wansley out in front, number 39, and enables Rogers to go in to score and change the scoreboard with another touchdown. But I was telling a story about McKenzie. So McKenzie is taking all these plays. And so when Grimm makes the Pro Bowl team, he said, congratulations, Russ. I'm glad you made the Pro Bowl team. And I'm looking forward to the trip. And Grimm says, what are you talking about? He said, well, you're going to have somebody practice for you, don't you?
Left in the third quarter. There is Santa Claus. Merry Christmas, everyone. And the kick will come from Cox, and the deep man is Ron Wolford. Cardinals had better do something quickly, Hank, or they're dead in this one, right?
Yeah, it looks like they're in serious trouble. Really does.
Wolfley gives way to Nelson. Nelson, who is not extremely fast, came across to the 30-yard line with a spirit to return. He worked hard. Last four times the Cardinals have had the ball, they punted, and then for the sake of doing something different, they punted again.
Right. But Nelson's been around a long time. I coached against him many, many times. He'll be with the Philadelphia playing him twice a year.
He's a trier.
He's a true veteran, this guy is. You know, he's a little disappointed that he's lost his starting position, but he still makes a contribution.
Yeah, he really does. It's a surprising thing, Dick. You know, you kind of think he's going to be replaced every year, but he's always here, isn't he?
Well, St. Louis had better do something. They trail by 11. toward the tail end of this third quarter. Short drop, quick pass, and a few yards for Roy Green with Darryl Green on top of it. Darryl gave him a little shove and make certain he did go out of bounds. They've got a lot of speed in that Redskin backfield now with the addition of a couple of youngsters.
Darryl Green
and Cherry.
Oh, I know it. You know, and that the Cherry played quarterback at the University of Hawaii, believe this or not. And when he threw the ball real well, he said that was a cherry bomb.
2 yard pickup on the pass to Green. Look at that total offense. Just about double. And a draw play, and Mitchell. It's only a yard or two. Play finished off by Mel Kaufman after Vernon Dean had forced it. Third down coming up.
This is the play they've had more success with than anything else, running the ball. Draw play, plain draw play. Slips off the tackle there, and Kaufman comes in there, number 55, and finally makes the tackle. Not a good one, but he got him down.
Third and seven. Cardinals have punted four times in a row. And if they fail to click on this one, they'll have to do it again.
Monty Coleman, 51, did a great job.
He did a great job. And I think this is why the Redskins defensive coach is saying that this guy is one of the fine nickel linebackers in football. Now, see if I can locate Monty Coleman. I think that's him right here, a linebacker. Now, he'll take a back man-to-man, and you'll see they'll try to pick him off. And see, now he's got him right there. They're going out and up on him. And this guy does a super job. Many people will play a sixth defensive back in that position.
And he had the presence to give him a jam, too.
Yeah.
You see that, Dick? That really slowed him down.
Burks on a bad kick. And a good bounce.
Feel the ball.
Ooh, what a good hit by Wolfley, that fullback, number 24. He's a tough cookie. He's a newcomer to the league out of West Virginia.
I can see why Jim Hannifin really likes this Wolfley. He talked about him in the locker room yesterday, and he gets fired up just talking about him. He says he will put you down as a tackler, and he will put you down as a blocker, as well as anybody he's ever coached.
He reminds me an awful lot of Jim Otis when he played here.
Really?
Same kind of, yeah, same
Otis
build, same
is a little
kind
bigger,
of, yeah. Yep. Watch 24 in the middle of the screen. Watch him coming from the backside. And he leaps up on top. You talk about sacrificing your body. He does it, doesn't he?
There's a 54-yard punt with the help of that good bounce. The Redskins are back at that 17. All they have to do is start Rodgers going and make sure he doesn't drop the ball. Uh-oh. I didn't expect that. There's a flag.
Yeah, he grabbed him.
Leonard Smith grabbed Ditter when he was going by.
That was a great call because they run the hitch, Hank, about three or four times on first down. That time they ran the hitch and go.
Uh-huh.
And I think going into the game, they thought that Ditter would get the matchup on Leonard Smith, who is a strong safety. And Smith usually is very efficient when he's right outside of the tight end. Now he's one-on-one on the outside. It's a little different.
Like what? Playing a corner position.
Yep.
By the way, Leonard Smith, who was...
Holding, defense, number 45. 5 yards.
This kid could have made the Pro Bowl. He's a good player.
Watch Ditter. Now he's on the outside. He's got outside leverage. Doesn't do anything as far as jamming. He makes a little move inside and then runs right by him. He gets caught on the fake and gives him a shot in the back.
That's a pretty ticky flag, wasn't it?
Well, no, you can't jam him beyond 5 yards.
So,
yeah, he gave him a shot in the back as he went by, didn't he?
Yeah.
First down at the 22.
Ooh.
That's the second time in this second half that Rodgers had a wide open lane and slipped.
Yeah.
How are the Redskins feeling along the sideline? Well, they
feeling
think
better.
They have things in control.
Vernon Dean right there.
They'll just count on the Cowboys.
Stuart Anderson.
Do it.
Yeah.
They want the Cowboys to do a job for him tomorrow. We have a player injured on that last effort.
Who's down?
20 seconds. Is that EJ again? 20 seconds left in the third quarter. E.J. Jr. made the tackle and another Cardinal player is hurt. Here's the Cardinal bench. 5-10 record.
There's Bob Harris. He was a starting linebacker last year. Came here a couple years ago as a strong safety and played outside linebacker and played well.
He's had a couple of injuries and kept him out of the lineup.
Yeah, well, Freddie Joe Nunn, the number one pick, you know, I think took his spot, really, didn't he, Jack?
Yeah. I think Nunn had only moderate success as a first-year player. Tomorrow, the schedule. Final regular season Sunday, Atlanta, New Orleans, Bears and Detroit, Green Bay and Tampa Bay, Philadelphia and the Vikings, and the big doubleheader game on CBS tomorrow. After it all starts at 12:30 Eastern time, the Cowboys at San Francisco. And even if the Redskins win here, their fate will not be determined until that game is over. Giants are in the playoffs as a wild card team. They won today. They knocked off the Pittsburgh Steelers. And as they work on the injured player,
that's Stafford Mays
they're working on. What with the Steelers losing today, Cleveland becomes the champions of the AFC Central, and it knocks Cincinnati and the Steelers both out of the playoffs. And so the picture is a lot clearer now.
Good job done at Cleveland by Monty Schottenheimer.
Let's see what happens to Stafford Mays, Cardinal player, number 76.
Stafford Mays, I think, is this guy right here. Now, you follow him as the play develops. Defensive left hand. It's influence block, and he got his foot caught up underneath him as he got blocked.
And then it looked like somebody fell on it, didn't it?
Yeah. We used to hate to play on this turf. Now they have a new artificial turf, but the old one, Hank, was like playing on the street.
Yeah, that's, you talk about fuzzy cement. That's what it was.
See, he's got his right there. You can see right here, he's got his foot planted. Roll it. Second guy in, another angle now. Defensive lineman. He makes a good charge. Gets twisted there. He gets his foot caught underneath him right there.
Now we see it. And he is being helped off of the field right at the moment. Stafford Mays.
Yeah, that's going to leave him a little short because Curtis Greer hasn't played today either.
There he is. Greer is in there now for the first time.
Well, he's banged up.
Number 75, Curtis Greer, who is going to have a knee operation Monday, is playing the defensive end. Well, that marks the end of the third quarter. When we come back, the ball will be at the Redskin 30, and it'll be second down and two. End of the third quarter, the score 20-9 Washington. We now pause for a word from your local station.
And by Energizer Batteries, America's newest bundle of energy.
They had about 3 inches of snow here in St. Louis last Thursday night. Field in rather good playing condition. Second down and two from the 30-yard line for Washington. Rodgers again. First down. Well, let's see what kind of forward progress they give him. It may not be a first down. The tackle by Galloway. But apparently they're going to mark it short, making a third down in about a foot. They're going to measure. Just started the fourth quarter here. Joe Gibbs across the way. His team will have their meeting on Monday. And they'll know whether they're going home or going to the Meadowlands to play the Giants.
He's done a real good job of keeping them together through some adverse times this year. You know, losing early in the season. They did that same thing last year, Jack. They lost early. Hank, remember, and they made a run and got in. And he says that he can't figure out why they are starting out poorly. You know, they've given it and second-guessed everything they've done and evaluated it and still can't pinpoint the reason.
And Neil Okowicz said, you know, this is the most rewarding season I've ever had.
That's what he said. He told us both that.
Yeah, he said that yesterday in the meeting. He said it really is the most rewarding season because we've been able to withstand a lot of adversity. We held together and hang tough. Even when we lost Joe Theismann and all those things happened to us, we're hanging in there tough.
Third down in inches. Rodgers kept those legs going.
Boy, he's strong.
He got a first down. The front four for the Cardinals is their usual starting four. Al Baker at left end, Mark Duda left tackle, David Galloway right tackle, and Curtis Greer, the right defensive end. Nunn made that tackle. Along the Cardinals sideline is Jim Hanifin. He'll go home after this game and wonder what's going to happen. They're going to dump me. They're going to give me another chance.
I hope they keep him. This is one of the nice people in football. Really a great guy.
Yeah, I'd hate to see him leave. I really would. He's a terrific guy, and he just had a terrible season, and he can't put his finger on it, but it's just one of those years.
Good strong tackling after Rodgers had gained a couple of yards, and he ran into the arms of Mark Duda, number 73.
As we sat with Jim Hannaford in the locker room yesterday, Hank and I were down there. He said, you know, guys, you've been in it. He says, this season has been a nightmare. One thing after another. Early in the season, I lose two best defensive backs, Benny Perrin and Lionel Washington. Those guys go down one thing after another.
And he lost his offensive coordinator, Rod Dalauer, and he lost Tom
offensive
Bettis.
Offensive line coach.
He lost his defensive coordinator.
Yeah, he lost Tom Bettis, who has done a great job with the Cleveland Browns.
Second down here. Nice safe pass and a first down. Nice safe pass to Gary Clark. Redskins aren't taking any chances, and it looks like Schrader is going to be 4-1 as a Redskins starter.
That's the kind of passing they've been doing all year, really, because they're 27th in the league in yards per pass completion, believe it or not. And in the past, they've always been much more efficient getting the ball down field further. Look at this, guys.
Total offense, second half, minus 3 yards for St. Louis.
Would you call that domination?
That's terrible. First and 10 from the 46. Rodgers again. Look at that. He's going to be close to 200 yards in a couple of more carries. And Leonard Smith had to carry him. And they blew that defensive line wide open, Hank.
Watch the big hole and watch the good move by Rodgers. They come off the line of scrimmage, and he cuts back behind the block of the right guard, breaks into the open, looking to the right side, anticipates the hit by Leonard Smith, and covers up the football to make sure he doesn't fumble.
Rodgers has carried 28 times, 171 yards.
He likes to run against St. Louis, doesn't he?
I can see why.
Try it again, George. Isn't that something? First down.
Hank, you called it right. You said he runs better in the fourth quarter. We're in that fourth quarter and his motor's running.
He's going strong, isn't he?
Young and Smith made the tackle. And John Riggins said, no, I don't want to go in for any token appearance. He's only two rushing touchdowns away from Jim Brown's record. He said, I don't want him under adverse or unusual circumstances. I want to earn him.
He said, if you need me to help you win, put me in there.
Yeah, he didn't worry about getting a letter.
Yeah,
for an appearance of the game.
But that must mean he's going to come back.
He said definitely he will come back.
First down at the 13.
Where else are you going to make that kind of money?
Huh? Yeah, well, that's right. I think Rodgers got a little pooped. He was running straight up with the ball that time.
Yeah, and Skins, you know, so far, Jack, have made 25 first downs. Rodgers has made 13 of those first downs.
191 yards for George Rodgers.
Well, he only has then 15
Cardinals.
Yards to go, and he'll break his all-time rushing record of 206 yards. That was in 1983 against St. Louis.
Ball's at the 10. Second down and 7.
And look how deep he is. He's about 7 yards deep, and this is where he's really effective and very efficient when he's back there deep enough to see what's happening up front.
Schrader got it back.
George that time missed a block on Freddie Joe Nunn, who was blitzing. Rodgers looked like he was supposed to block and missed a block, and that's where we got the sack.
The third of the day against Schrader. Duda and Nunn were in on the sack, and here comes Griffin in. I told you I thought Rodgers was a little pooped, and he's gone out of the game east to the sideline.
Yeah, he was looking for the fire department.
The rescue truck.
That's right. You'll resuscitate it.
Ball's at the 14. Third down, 11. 9.5 left in the game. Little slant in, a little look in pass, and it is incomplete. Incomplete to Didier, the big guy, and he's 6'5". had trouble getting down to the deck, and Cedric Mack covered it.
I hate to belabor the point, but there again, it's amazing how many balls Trader throws falling away from the ball.
I was talking to Sonny Jurgensen about that.
Amazing.
He said he does it an awful lot.
I did the Eagle-Redskin game 2 weeks ago, Hank, and I noticed him doing that a number of times. He has such a strong arm, he can get away with it more than most quarterbacks can.
Yeah, most of the time, but still and all, he doesn't get the ball on target like he should. That one's a little low because he hurt himself.
Mosley has made two, missed two, and misses another. A 32-yard miss, and Mosley is two out of five, and the lead is still 11 points. Well, Mosley is now 22 out of 34 for the year. Missed his third of the day. With this score, you'd say the Cardinals still have a good chance. But the way they've been failing to move the ball on offense.
Look at Mosley's reaction, Jack. Look at Mosley.
That's his third miss of the day. He's not used to that.
No, I can't believe it.
And he's such a proud guy.
Yeah.
Well, it hurts when he misses a kick.
Yeah. There'll be speculation about him retiring, I'm sure.
He's made only two out of his last seven. He ought to come kick for the Cardinals, where they've been going. Well, from the 20-yard line, Mitchell gets knocked down, and with 9:18 left, the Redskins say, run the ball all you want, fellas.
And talking about kickers, Jan Stenerud is going to kick his last kick tomorrow in the game with Minnesota. You'll see that game.
Yeah, I'll be there.
Yeah. But, boy, what a great kicker he's been through the years.
Yeah.
I talked to him the other day. I tried to talk him into holding off. Don't say anything about retiring until you make sure. Wait till spring to make that decision.
Yeah.
But he said, no, coach. He said, I think it's over.
He's got a lot of pride.
He's a very proud guy. And the fact that he missed four field goals last week, or three field goals and an extra point, really hurt him.
Second and 11. Mitchell makes it short of a first down by a narrow margin. Third down coming up. Tomorrow, another full schedule, and at 12:30 Eastern time, the NFL Today, and they're going to speculate on coaching changes in the NFL. Summarize the playoff picture for you. Irv Cross will be in San Francisco to set the stage for that Dallas 49er game, which you'll see on CBS tomorrow. Third down and a foot. The Cardinals have made a first down only once in 10 tries. And now they get motion from Wolfley. And that'll make it third down and six.
That's the second time that's happened in this game.
Isn't that something?
Yep.
I don't know whether you blame the individual involved or you blame the coaching or what you do, but everything seems to crumble for this team.
This late in the season, you have those...
Still third down.
Those kind of mistakes, Jack, it's got to be concentration.
Oh, yeah.
It's got to be a lack of concentration,
yeah.
You know.
That's the second time in short yardage, as you've already stated, but you know what happens? A team has great expectations. They report to training camp. They get the season going. They expect to be a playoff team, and when they see that not develop, I think the attitude changes and affects the performance week in and week out.
Yeah, I think you're right, Dick. That's the worst situation in the world. They have high hopes and expectations and never fulfill them.
Yeah.
That's murder.
Third down and six. Ernest Gray is the additional wide receiver. Ball batted down by Green, intended for Green. Darrell Green knocked it down. There's George Rogers, who's had a big, big rushing day here today, and he's gone over 1,000 yards for the third season during his career.
He'll sleep well tonight.
Yeah, I know. He came into this ball game with seven runs over 25 yards. 30 rushes for 191 yards, one touchdown. He's earned his paycheck today.
Birdsong will punt to Darrell Green. The Redskins will get the ball. They lead by 11. Well, they still have a chance. They'll count on the Cowboys knocking off the 49ers. Good punt by Birdsong. Green, well covered, gets away from two guys. Taken down from behind at the 40. Now Washington wants to knock off some of the 7:16 left in this game. That's all. Redskins have an 11-point lead and the ball. Wolfie, number 24, knows that he messed up a moment ago, Hank. He feels badly about it.
Yeah, but the thing about Wolfie, a guy like him, you know, every mistake or any mistake he makes is an honest mistake. You know, yeah. Jack, he's trying all the time, hustling all the time. He's going to be a big asset to this football team in the years to come.
Al Rogers again. Might as well get 200 while you're about it, George. He got about a yard or so. The actual attendance here today was 28,090. Curtis Greer just made that tackle, number 75. They sold about 45,000 tickets, but they had 28,000 here, and a lot of those people have left. We told you about Greer, number 75, the right defensive end. He's going to have a knee operation on Monday. He's had a struggling year because of that bad knee. Schrader throw it? Nope. Well, they're getting to Rogers a little bit now. It's going to be third down and long. You know, as we wish you a Merry Christmas from CBS, we certainly are doing so without forgetting about the families affected by that terrible tragedy, the crash of the people in the 101st Airborne Division. And our thoughts go out to them. It is third down coming up here, third and seven. That's a terrible thing, wasn't it, Dick?
Oh, my gosh. I mean, and I used to think losing a football game was tragic, you know? It puts it all in the right perspective, doesn't it?
Third down here, third and seven. He's there. Whoa, what a catch. What a catch by Gary Clark.
He is a pistol, isn't he?
Huh? He is something.
Hank, these Redskins didn't go start perking till he got here.
Washington bumping around without a bump, and look at Washington trying to catch him from the backside. Runs right by him and he catches the ball at the end of the ball that time.
Yeah, in all fairness,
sensational catch.
In all fairness to Lionel Washington, he's just coming off a broken fibula and he can't run like he could.
No, he said that yesterday. Not 100% yet. Look at now. Watch Schrader.
Good protection.
Pushes off the right foot. Excellent pass protection, plenty of time to throw the ball, and really a beautiful shot and a great, great catch by Gary Clark, number 84.
He's caught eight passes today and one for a touchdown. Pretty good throw by Schrader, too, wasn't it? Here comes Rogers. He's down to about the 12-yard line, and the Cardinal bench along the sideline has been a terrible year, punctuated by another loss here on the final weekend.
You know, there are a lot of football fans that don't realize how much pro football players really care about winning. You know, they think they only play because they make the big money and all that stuff. These guys on Sunday don't think about how much money they're making. They think about trying to win, and when they don't, it really hurts.
The ball is at the 12. It's second and four. I guess Rodgers is trying for 200 now. Can he accelerate?
And he loves to run right. Boy, yeah. He feels much better running to the right. You can see it when he runs.
It's first and goal. We'll let you know when he reaches the 200-yard mark, which he may do. He wants a little breather here now.
He said he feels a lot faster on the AstroTurf than he does on the natural grass.
Washington first and goal.
There's Joe Bostic. He's in the middle of things here because he's the player rep. And you know that the Cardinals wanted the players to take a physical, including a urinalysis, the postseason event. They say, well, the season isn't over yet. We're not going to do it. Seven of them said they would, but the others wouldn't, and Bostic's in the middle of it. First and goal. 206 yards for Rogers. Now, Keith Griffin gets about half of that. There are two Bostics playing, you know, the center for the Redskins and the guard for the Cardinals. The older brother is Joe. One of them's going to, well, maybe both of them will be out of the playoffs at Christmas. We don't know.
Their parents are here, and they just root for the offensive teams. They don't root for the total unit or total organization. They just root for each offensive team to play well.
I thought one side on one side of the field, the other one on the other one, just to make sure there wasn't any prejudice.
Second and goal inside the three.
See if they follow Highway 66 and 68 here.
Yeah.
No, they're going the other way.
Griffin. He did not get in. watch it. The reason I was laughing, I watched Jim Tunney, the referee, ducked his head. He said, let me out of here, man.
Look at Jacoby. He steps in amongst those guys. He's a whole helmet taller than the rest of them. And I would stop fighting as soon as he got around me, too. Wouldn't you, Hank?
Yeah, sure would. That's a good sign to stop at all.
Pretty good move by Tunney to get his head out of the way, man. He ducked in a hurry. Jeff Bostic's in the middle of this.
There you see Nico Noga, and there you see 53, Bostic. He gets a shove out of the picture, and it pushes back. It's a little taffy pull there. Boys will be boys, you know.
They're down and goal. Griffin. And a touchdown for the Redskins. The score is 26-9. You know, the Cardinals got all of their points in the first quarter, got off to a 9-0 lead. And Hanifin says, well, here's a little more I have to swallow.
You know, Hanifin and Joe Gibbs are old friends and go back coaching together all the way at San Diego State, then here at St. Louis Cardinals.
Those stories that Hanifin told the other day, priceless, weren't they?
Nobody can tell stories any better than Jim Hanifin. And, you know, he's such an honest, sincere guy, and does he ever care? Holy mackerel.
There's Nico Noga, the linebacker, number 57, who's shaken up, and Leonard Smith is yelling for Charlie Picker to get out there on the field.
Nico Noga played for an ex-assistant coach of mine at UCLA at the University of Hawaii, Dick Tomey. And Dick Tomey, he said, this guy is a real player. And he actually thinks he'd play better inside than he would outside.
You know, talking to him about 2 weeks ago, we asked him what he was going to do in the offseason to get ready for next season.
Mosley makes it 27-9. Well, you know that these Redskins got off to a very slow start, whereas the Cardinals were 3-1, the Redskins were 1-3.
Three, right.
And now they have a record of 9-6, and this will make it 10-6.
You know, and I was on the practice field of the Redskin training camp one day and watched them practice, and I left there saying, that's as impressive a football practice as I've ever seen. This football team will win 13, 14 games. I felt that. I really did. And they, all of a sudden, the Cowboys, remember, got after them something viciously in that first ball game, and they just couldn't get going early.
I think they stunned them a little bit. I don't think they expected that. I think they had beaten the Cowboys prior to that game, what, 4 or 5 times? I forget how many.
They had beaten them.
I don't know what the number was. And I think it was kind of a shock for them. And I think it took a little time to recover from that shock. And then when they went to Chicago and get bombed again, they really started to scratch their head a little bit and try to figure out what was happening.
Yeah.
They can win when they're on the road, too. This will be their 5th road win. And they'll be 21-8 of their most recent road games. This fellow does a good job of coaching them. There's the Cardinal bench.
They've won 24 straight games when a running back has rushed for 100 yards or more. And here we have Rodgers going for 200. They ought to win 2 games on that, shouldn't they?
They'll double dip.
Double dip, yeah.
You know, one thing you never hear Hanifin do, you never hear him rip a player. He never says so-and-so is bad or so-and-so did this. They say the team didn't play well, but he protects his players as best he can. Here's a squib kick. Washington recovered one of these earlier. It's picked up by Wolf Link. He can't get outside. He can't get to the 20-yard line. And the running back, special teams player, Reggie Branch, got down there and made the tackle at the 2-minute mark. The Redskins are home free here, leading 27-9. This is Joe Jacoby. It looks like Hot Springs, Arkansas, with the steam coming off of his head.
No, Joe Jacoby's 6'7", 305 pounds. His wife, Irene, is 6'1". Can you imagine the young offensive tackles they're going to raise in today?
Second half of the season, the Redskins under Joe Gibbs have always finished very strongly. In 82, it only totals 7 games because of the strike. They are strong at the tail end of the year, and if they get into the playoffs, they'll acquit themselves very well.
You bet. I think the same thing of the 49ers. If they make it in there, watch out.
Mm-hmm. There's George Rogers. He had a big day. He went over the 200-yard mark, 206, and 1 touchdown.
He's got a great smile.
He fumbled.
It lights up like a Christmas tree.
Fumbled earlier in the game, but then came back and had a strong contest. Lomax is 16 out of 24, but he's been sacked 4 times. The inside hat handoff to Mitchell. I want to tell you something, folks. There are no harder worker in football than this little guy, Stump Mitchell. He's only 5'9".
You know, he needed 124 yards coming into this ball game to go to 1,000. I wonder what he's got.
I think he's still a little short.
This is watch Doug Dawson on a trap block on the outside. Look at the big hole. He finds plenty of running room. Green downfield trying to make a block. He straight arms Darryl Green, goes down the far side of the field, and is finally caught by Darryl Green the second time around.
And that gives him 1,000. He got 129 yards, and he's over 1,000 yards. And brother, I know the kid pretty well, and they love him. That was a 64-yard run. We have 128 left. Look at the affection they have for little Stump Mitchell. In a losing effort, Stump Mitchell has gone over the 1,000-yard mark this year. And you can tell how much they like him on the squad, Hank.
I can't understand why people call him Stump instead of Livonia. That's his real name. That's his first name, you know.
It's a first down at the 18-yard line of Washington. And Lomax runs, fakes, runs, get out of bounds, first and goal.
He has a different dimension to the offense when he does that. You know, Dick, he hasn't done it hardly at all during the course of the season. But when he, you know, when you talk to teams who are going to play the Cardinals, they all say, well, the one thing we got to do is keep him in the pocket.
Yeah.
And if he doesn't run, then he don't have to worry about keeping him in the pocket. And there was a great demonstration of course, I know now that, you know, the game's over for all practical purposes, and they're playing back and playing soft. But still, everybody on the offense is defense except one guy, as you know, Dick. And if he can run, he creates a lot of problems.
First and goal at the 4. That time, Darryl Green wouldn't let Roy Green get behind him.
The side judge was open. He almost hit him that time.
1:16 remaining. They bring in Ernest Gray for the Cardinals. Really tough, Dick Vermeil, to run against these Redskins in the goal line situation.
They are tough to run on anywhere. They've only given up 105 yards a game rushing. They have forced people to move the ball 151 yards per touchdown or run 32 plays per touchdown. That's a lot. No, that's a real efficient defense.
Second and goal.
And they play, make them play in a very long field, too.
Yes, that's right.
Three wide receivers. Gray in motion. Lomax hits Gray, and he is taken out of bounds with a strong tackle by Wilburn. Barry Wilburn out of Mississippi. Gray's a pretty good sized fellow at 6'3 and 195, but Wilburn handled him okay.
Yeah, he did. He was, I know Wilburn, you know this kid, he was a National Honor Society student, this guy.
Well, he's
nice
smarter
to have those guys
am.
With brains in the secondary.
He's smarter than I am, if he was.
Me too.
Got to be careful not smarter than the coach, though. That's probably the thing you have to worry about.
44 seconds left in the game, clock running. Knocked down at the last moment by Malat, the linebacker. And it is fourth down. It was first and goal at the 4. Now it's fourth down. Intended for Roy Green. Annabelle would like to see his squad get in there. They haven't scored since the first quarter. And he sends in Clyde Duncan. There's a big part of the Cardinals story. Duncan was the number one draft pick a year ago. He's caught 3 balls in 2 years.
I wonder what that is, dollar per catch.
He's number 86, and he goes to the left. They signed him and found out he couldn't catch the ball.
Everybody makes mistakes. The only guy that doesn't make a mistake in the draft, the guy that never drafts anybody.
You run it in, kid. Now you may or may not. Touchdown. And that was to Duncan, and that's his first professional touchdown. It's the first professional touchdown for Clyde Duncan out of Tennessee, number one draft pick 2 years ago.
Yeah, he was sliding around in the end zone that time, Jack, and finally popped wide open.
Yeah.
And Lomax saw him as he ran over to the left side. But he's happy about that, even though it's just this time of the year and the last game of the season.
He's still happy about making his first touchdown catch. Here he is, looking to the right, up the middle, then breaks to the left, jumps to the outside, and there he hits him. But wide open in the end zone for the touchdown.
With 27 seconds left in the game. And Boyovich makes it 27-16. 27 seconds left. Executive producer, CBS Sports, is Terry O'Neill. Senior producer, Charles Milton. Produced today by Robert Stenner. Our director, Robert Fishman. Associate producers, Michael Burks and Mark Wolf. Field technical manager, Wilbur Allmeyer. Broadcast associates, Pierce O'Neill and Greg Callender. And others involved in our telecast, and all of these folks, as well as those of us up here in the booth, wish you a Merry Christmas and a happy holiday season. Please be careful with that driving. Let the non-drinkers drive the car. And be sure to tune in tomorrow for NFL football in your area. Check the local listing. Then everybody gets to see the Cowboys at Candlestick Park against the 49ers. The Redskins have won here. But in order for them to get in the playoff, they have to have the Cowboys beat the 49ers. Wouldn't that be ironic if their vaunted enemy, the Cowboys, put them in the playoffs?
It would be tough, I think, for the Cowboys to play a super game when they've already clinched everything. You go in there thinking, should I play my top running back? Should Dorsett carry the ball more than 10 times? Should I, you know, all the different positions, you're worried about a guy getting hurt. Isn't that right, Hank?
Yeah, I think so. Plus the fact, you know, Dick, you don't know who's going to play quarterback there. Yeah. For the Cowboys tomorrow. You don't know who that's going to be.
Here's the onside kick try. Who has the ball? Cardinals tried that earlier in the game when they were leading by the score of 9-0. And it kind of changed this one around to the point the Redskins led at the half 13-9. And the Cardinals, who scored 9 in the first quarter, didn't score until a moment ago. Jim Tunney is the referee here today. Ordinarily, these crew of officials exchange gifts at Christmas time, but not on this trip. Tunney and his fellow officials invited some kids to the football game, some disadvantaged kids from the area, took them to breakfast this morning, brought them to the stadium, got them some little gifts, caps and so forth, and a very nice Christmas approach by the officials here today.
Yeah, very thoughtful and a great gesture on their part. Terrific.
They were never that nice to me when I was coaching, Hank.
No.
Dick Vermeil, on behalf of Hank Stram, nice to have you with us, and we'll be together on a future playoff game this year.
Well, look forward to it.
Actually, it'll be next year, 1986. Yeah. The final score, 27-16, as the Redskins have won an additional game. The Cardinals finished 5-11, the Redskins 10-6, but the Redskins may not get into the playoffs.
27-16 yesterday, the Redskins finished their season with 3 straight wins. And in the winning, they saw a couple of people emerge that they were counting on this year. Remember when training camp opened? You remember that the big questions then on the offensive side of the ball concerned how George Rogers would fit in and whether or not Jeff Bostic could possibly make it back from a crippling knee injury. The answers to those questions begin with George Rogers and the scare he gave us.
The first play of the football game, the Redskins had hoped to set the tempo with a big run. George Rogers came up with a big fumble.
Cardinals football.
What do you say to him on the sidelines after he's fumbled?
Well, sometimes you can't repeat all the words that are said, but he kind of gets the message.
By game's end, the fumble had almost been forgotten because George Rogers ran like no Washington back has run before. 206 yards, breaking Mike Thomas's 9-year-old single-game record.
What do we say, George blossomed today?
I think George blossomed 3 weeks ago, but this was certainly a culmination of him gaining the respect of everyone in the organization three weeks ago when he carried the ball against Philadelphia 36 times and had an outstanding performance. I think this is all a confidence-building thing that's continuing to mushroom now.
George really has come around.
Yeah, he has. He really has. The guy makes tons of yards. If you just get him to hang on to the football while he's doing it, we'll be all right.
So George wanted to come out, and you guys wouldn't let him out?
Oh, he was moaning and groaning all week about he wants to get 1,000 yards. So we got him over 1,000 yards, and he started getting close to 200, and he wanted to come out. We says, no. He said, well, you ain't coming out. He said, you're going to run with it. So we got him up over 200 for a record, and I think that's a tribute to him. He ran hard and played hard, especially, you know, he fumbled a couple times last week, and he comes out and very first play fumbles again. I mean, he could have went in the bag, but he came out and he ran hard the rest of the game.
Earlier in the week, he said if he got 1,000, he'll take us on a trip. So that's a little motivation factor.
A trip where?
That we don't know yet. It might be the Ocean City. I don't know. It might be downtown D.C.
Could be Rockville.